Office's One Call That's All studio at the Avenue in downtown Milwaukee. This is Kyle Brusten Nortman, KBN, on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
Outside of the birth of my baby daughter, this might be my favorite day of 2024 thus far. Free agency, legal tampering has begun. The new league year starts on Wednesday, and the Packers are getting busy. Josh Jacobs reportedly signing to the Green Bay Packers, the running back who led the NFL in rush yards in 2022. Took a minor step back in 23, but is young, and my hope is he'll be joining Aaron Jones. No word on Aaron Jones yet. I'm Ben Bruss alongside Kyle Wallace, the Packer backer. Say something, Kyle.
Oh, it's a good day to be a Packer. Real good day. Goody making some moves. What you just say is this is your favorite day? Or you?
It's been my favorite day of 2024 outside the birth of my baby girl.
And the Packers getting busy.
They're getting busy.
We love getting busy.
That's Kyle Wallace. Brad Nortman, longtime NFL punter, our second place Brad. How are you?
I'm good. I'm back from pink eye. Immunized.
Oh, yeah.
Immunized, some might say, from pink eye. And perfect time to be back in person with my guys because there's headlines all over the place, and I'm loving it.
Yeah, it is a fast and crazy world out there in the NFL. I do want to point out that Kirk Cousins also was traded to Atlanta, which is interesting as it turns out that, you know, Jordan Love is going to be extended likely here. I think he's eligible soon.
Like that.
And when he is, do you like that? Do you like that? Just got another $180 million, not all guaranteed, but that's 4 years, $180. We've been doing the yo-dee-yo-dee game in which we're guessing how much Jordan Love is going to make on an average annual basis. I mean, Daniel Jones was the early benchmark. A torn Achilles, old Kirk Cousins, $45 million a year. That's some bargaining chip for for Jordan Love's camp.
Yeah, it sure is. I mean, that's eye-popping numbers. I love me some Kirk Cousins. I probably like him more than everybody else. But if I like Kirk Cousins, I love Jordan Love. And if Kirk Cousins is getting $45 million, my goodness, says a lot for our boy Jordan Love.
I mean, you said this when the salary cap came out a couple weeks ago. You said that price is just going to go up for Jordan Love now because they don't evaluate just purely based on, oh, you're this talented. You get no, it's based off how much is available in the cap and how much of the cap you're taking up. And I think we're already seeing the result of that right now, of the fact that Kirk Cousins is getting $45 million. If the cap doesn't go up significantly more than what was expected, I don't know if he's getting all that. I don't think he's getting $45 million. So we better sign Jordan Love. We better sign him soon. As soon as May come around, I better have him sign that dotted line.
Well, that's my takeaway, right? Is when I look at that, I think, oh my goodness, the Packers need to sign Jordan Love as soon as possible. Because whenever teams do this, whether it be Lamar Jackson for the Ravens or Dak Prescott for the Cowboys, or even Kirk Cousins for the Commanders at the time, then working his way over to the Vikings, whenever teams play the waiting game with a quarterback who's worth a darn, they always end up paying more at the end. So we know Jordan Love is a very good quarterback. Got to pay him as soon as possible. That price tag is going to keep going up.
So a lot happening in, I don't want to say this one is confirmed yet because it's a local reporter.
Uh-oh.
But Eagles are also signing another Giants player because they signed Saquon Barkley, but safety Xavier McKinney.
Oh! Wow.
Now I'm waiting on Shefty. I'm waiting on Shefty and Rapp. I'm waiting on the big boys here. But the safety market is flooded. And let's just get back to Josh Jacobs here for a second because that is big news. When Goot goes out and goes and gets a Josh Jacobs, that is a big thing to me because I only think it matters, though, if Aaron Jones is back. And I think it's leading me to the idea of, like, those two are a great 1-2 combo, and if you said A.J. Dillon and Aaron Jones heading into a couple years ago when people were like, this is going to be the best 1-2 punch in the league, well, we know what Aaron Jones is, and we know that Josh Jacobs is a capable running back. He led the league in rushing yards. You put those two together, woo!
Well, a powerful thing is a 1-2 running back combination, okay?
Pow!
powerful. When I played for Carolina, we had headlining running backs of D'Angelo Williams and Jonathan Stewart. Those are two guys that were no nonsense, got together great, tough, physical, fast, and it worked out great. When one's off, the other one stepped up. When they're both healthy, they just keep pounding the rock at you. And honestly, two things with Jacksonville as well. Chris Ivory, TJ Yeldon, and Leonard Fournette and TJ Yeldon. Every time that I had success, personally speaking now, in the NFL, it was with two running backs that could be marquee running backs on another team. It's going to help keep Aaron Jones fresh. It'll keep Josh Jacobs fresh. Imagine being on the defensive side of the football, right? Imagine game planning against the Green Bay Packers, and you give Josh Jacobs 5 carries, and then you bring in a fresh Aaron Jones for 5 more carries, and then Josh Jacobs come in for more freshness. Look, this is going to be really powerful. Think of what this will do for Jordan Love opening up.
That's it.
Yep, because what's going to happen? Safeties are going to need to come enter the box. Linebackers are going to come enter the box. That's going to open downfield passing lanes for all these young wide receivers. I love what I see. Goody is doing amazing in this. And that's the other takeaway for me. Not only the on-field product for the Green Bay Packers, Goody, day one headlining player. It's a new thing for Goody.
And a running back as well. 800-990-3776. 800-990-ESPN. We're also on YouTube at ESPN Milwaukee, at ESPN Madison. You're listening to Kyle Bruston Nortman. Ben Brust, alongside who you just heard from, Brad Nortman, longtime NFL punter, and our Packer backer reacting to what Josh Jacobs is going to do for this team.
This is a championship move by Goody. This is what this is all about. This ain't about trying to win football games. This is about winning championships, because what did Goody say at the press conference at the NFL draft? He said, for us, it ain't about, you know, winning divisions. It's about winning titles and winning championships. And signing Josh Jacobs, someone who rushed for over 1,600 yards and 12 touchdowns just a season ago, and you add him with Aaron Jones, this is all about winning titles. And this is what I liked about the fact that Goody had his quarterback in Jordan Love. And we said that Goody didn't do enough to put around Aaron Rodgers. And you know what? He didn't, because he never signed to Josh Jacobs for our boy Aaron Rodgers, whether it was at the receiver or running back position or tight end position. He never signed somebody at this caliber to ever add to the offense. The fact that he has done this already after seeing Jordan Love just for one season, knowing we got something special in Jordan, let me put the pieces around him in positions of need, this team is going to thrive. So this is a championship move.
This is the biggest, I was going through in my head. This has to be the biggest signing that Goody's ever made, especially from a skill position standpoint, right? Because when you think about heading into 2019, it was Z Smith, P Smith, Billy Turner, and Adrian Amos. And then in the 2020 draft, Aaron Rodgers was on a live show with Pat McAfee talking about how, yeah, he'd be interested. He had a feeling that they were going to go wide receiver with a heavy wide receiver draft, and they did draft a skill position player, but it happened to be the quarterback, and they hadn't done that in 20 years, so he's hoping he was going to get a wide receiver. In terms of Goody's tenure, this has to be the biggest move that he's ever made from an offensive instant productivity standpoint, especially, and I think where he deserves credit for this is if he didn't hit last year, he would not have an opportunity to do this. And when I say hit in the NFL draft, if he didn't feel confident that he could come in with Watson, Dobbs, Reed, Wicks, and the two tight ends, if he didn't feel as if they were good in those positions, he would have to spend that money elsewhere. So not only do you may only have Aaron Jones for one more year next year because he's getting older, Josh Jacobs is likely going to be on this team. So you have a guy that you could have ready to go full-time when Aaron Jones is gone. Maybe you draft a running back later in this draft. Maybe you don't at all. But what Goody did in hitting in the 2023 draft in those skill position players is the reason why he was able to pull a move like this off.
That's a really good point, Ben, because what Goody is trained in, which is what Ted Thompson is trained in, which is what Ron Wolf was trained in, is you draft the best player available. You don't go after need, generally speaking. So if it comes down the line and it's your first round draft pick, your third round draft pick, and the best player available is blank, you just go with that. When you get in the position of you need to start drafting for a need, you start to reach. You start to overdraft. That is not what the Packers do. That's not part of their draft and develop plan. So by signing a running back, maybe they sign a safety over the next couple of days. What it does is It takes your needs and it starts to eliminate them. Everything then becomes a want. Goody is freed up in the drafting process to actually draft who he wants.
Yeah, no, this is an exciting move. Just for me, for overall what it means. I know you said it frees things up for drafting, which is fantastic. But what this offense can be is the thing that we should all be most excited about. What this can mean for Aaron Jones. I know some people think that, hey, this might be Aaron Jones. I hope Aaron Jones restructures his contract and he has, like I said before, a couple weeks ago. I would love to have him for a couple more years. Hopefully this gives him more gas in the tank. But this is a big move here by the Green Bay Packers and Goody.
800-990-3776. Dave from Aaron chimes in. He says, however, we lost a little bargaining chip with Jones because Saquon is getting $12.7 million for 3 years. Aaron Jones and Saquon Barkley are in different positions in their career. Saquon Barkley, still younger. Aaron Jones, been a Packer for the last 6-7 years. If I'm Aaron Jones at this point, someone's going to have to offer me $10 million, and it's got to be like the Niners, or it's got to be the Ravens. It's got to be a Super Bowl title contender. Because as Kyle said, if this is a championship move, maybe it's the move at the end of Aaron Jones' career, as he wants to continue to carry that G, right? Now he's like, okay, I'm going to restructure, because I don't want to miss out on what's happening here in Green Bay, especially after what he's seen from Jordan Love and what this team did last year.
Maybe he looks at this as an opportunity to extend his career here, because we talked about, and you brought this up, Kyle, of maybe you, what you do is you take that money he's owed and you spread it out. You spread it out over the course of 2 years, maybe 3 years, and maybe you think that Aaron Jones can actually do that because he has another feature back to complement. Because like Ben, what you said, this signing, this excites me. If you tell me it's Josh Jacobs and Aaron Jones, I'm over the moon. I'm more excited.
I'm going to tell you, it's Josh Jacobs and more to come. Josh Jacobs and more to come. That's exactly what this should be. This is foreshadowing that we are going to be active. I say we, because you know I am a stockholder and a shareholder in the Green Bay Packers. And I'm telling you,
what's the return on investment?
Cool. happiness, a lot of joy and happiness. And so this is only the beginning for the Green Bay Packers. Goody is not just going to sign Josh Jacobs
and be
done.
Oh, no, sorry. Breaking news, Chris.
What does that mean?
It's not good.
Now this is some breaking news.
The Green Bay Packers have now informed running back Aaron Jones of his release after talks broke down.
Wow. Dang.
So everything that we just talked about.
You for real?
Okay.
Throw it
out the window. Let's run it back.
All right. So Aaron Jones being released by.
They're going to bring him back, right?
It says after talks broke down of restructuring. I mean, he's hitting the open market.
The only way he comes back is if he explores the market and his options are zero, and he comes back to the Packers, whatever they offer.
But what this is telling me, if talks broke down, Goody's looking to see and say, I mean, the Saquon 12.7, it's interesting. He's getting 12 million, like 12.7, and Josh Jacobs, I don't have the details on that. But if I'm Aaron Jones, like, are you going to value me as much as that? You know, like, I could definitely see him not coming back, even if it's at a lower amount, because of how Josh Jacobs is coming into the fold and how he's already restructured twice. Brad, you want to feel valued as an NFL player, unless I'm wrong here.
No, I mean, yeah, this is... The Packers already made up their mind on this. But yeah, I mean, if how many times can you take a pay cut? How many times can you go backward? Because look, as an NFL player looking through your eyes, you realize, man, your career is fleeting. It's fast. You only have one window to make money. So every time you say, okay, I'll give up a little bit more. At some point, you have to put your foot in the ground and say no more. I think Aaron Jones hit that spot. And the Packers probably pushed him to see how much of a hometown discount could he get. So I hate to see it. This does change things. I almost need a minute to digest this a little bit.
Well, you're going to get a minute. Don't go anywhere. This is Kyle Bruston-Nortman across ESPN Wisconsin. Josh Jacobs signed to the Green Bay Packers, and as we were discussing how fun it would be to have those two out on the field together, Aaron Jones released from the Green Bay Packers. We'll be back. Don't go anywhere. Breaking down all things legal tampering, free agency. They should just start the new league year now. I mean, clearly conversations have been had. It's a dumb thing. But I love this day until Aaron Jones just, okay, before we go to break, I'm going to go on YouTube for ESPN Milwaukee and Madison for one last time. Wipe myself off. First down.
This is Kyle Bruston Nortman, KBN.
My offer, as we've come up with it at KBN, thanks to JD and Fondi, reutilizing Judy, who's still in my garage right now.
Is she a big booty Judy or a little flat flapjack booty Judy?
She's got a little something to her. I'll say that.
Why? She got some
Judy the
flapjack.
Judy the blow-up doll. She got a little something to her.
On ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com. When you shop online at Dell.com/deals, you'll have access to leading-edge technology and free shipping on everything. Again, that's Dell.com/deals. It's time for the Marquette Minute on 94.5 ESPN. Marquette fans, Buffalo Wild Wings is the official viewing party location for Marquette road games this season. The next watch party will be March 14th at the Oak Creek Buffalo Wild Wings for the Big East Tournament. Marquette watch parties will continue for all Big East and NCAA tournament games.
Senior night was spoiled for Tyler Kolek and Oso Iguodaro as the 8th-ranked Golden Eagles fell to number 2 UConn 74-67 at Fiserv Forum. After the game, head coach Chaka Smart gave an update on Kolek's injury status ahead of the Big East tournament next week.
I don't really want to prognosticate, you know, what the percentage chance he is to play in the Big East tournament, but he definitely is starting to feel better.
Marquette drops to 22-8 overall and 13-6 in Big East play. They wrap up regular season play Saturday afternoon at Xavier.
This has been the Marquette Minute on 94.5 ESPN. Check out the Golden Eagles watch party schedule at gomarquette.com/BWW for upcoming locations.
Hey, this is Jen Latta from Jen, Gabe, and Chewy. One of the best decisions I made recently was getting an infrared sauna from Good Health Saunas. They're a local business that's been around for 2 decades, based right in Appleton and Waukesha. Good Health Saunas are easy to install, cost as little as 25 cents a day, and include a true lifetime warranty. Even firefighters all across the country trust Good Health Saunas for sweating smoke out of their skin after fighting fire. Learn more at goodhealthsaunas.com. That's goodhealthsaunas.com.
This is Kyle Bruston Nortman, KBN, on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
Men about town, got them all shook and tripping, bust this trip, best of the beyond bounds.
Our fellow showmate, Mark Tauscher of Wilde and Tausch, 9 to noon across these very stations, 17 minutes ago. The Gutenator strikes again. Packers now have the best 1-2 punch at running back in the NFL. That will make LaFleur's offense even more effective in the play action game. Sorry, old T. And to be fair, we just had a 15-minute conversation about how excited we were about that, too. And then the breaking news was Aaron Jones released by the Green Bay Packers. You still do have Josh Jacobs. I'm going to turn it over to Kyle because, look, he came in from his little potty break, and he's like, I don't like this.
I don't like this. I gave you all. I said championships. There's a championship. All 5 minutes ago, there's a championship move. Ain't no championship move now. Now you're just replacing somebody, right? And here's the thing. Josh Jacobs, good running back. Very good running back. Still has something to prove. I know he led the league in rushing. It was fantastic. I like the duo as championship. I don't like Josh Jacobs by himself as championship. This throws a wrench in the plans for the Green Bay Packers.
It's interesting that you say that because Ricardo in Canada, 800-990-3776, hit me with your point here as Kyle wanted two running backs.
Guys, this is the NFL now, the new age NFL. Running backs, there's a dime a dozen coming out of the college. As soon as we sign Josh Jacobs, we're just going to draft one in the third or fourth round. You don't pay two running backs. It's bad business. This is the way it is. And this is why Goody is a good GM. Because he doesn't think with his heart like we do. He thinks with his head and his wallet.
Kyle
this
does.
Is a great play. I love Aaron Jones. I think he's one of the best all-time Packers. But unfortunately, he was injured a lot of the time, and you just don't pay two running backs. It's bad business. This is a good move, cutthroat. It's the kind of things that good teams do, a la Patriots, et cetera, et cetera. Good move. Draft someone coming out, the guy from Oregon, great running back. And that's how what's going to make us win. And remember, this is the Love team. It's not the running back team. That's just an accessory. You can't pay everybody.
I love it, Ricardo. Now, what I will say is, with it being Love's team, I really do think that the emergence of the three straight 100-yard games, when it really, really mattered for this team, obviously Love played well at times when Aaron Jones was hurt last year. But if you can get that consistency from Josh Jacobs, a little younger, more healthy, maybe he'll benefit from the Matt LaFleur scheme and what Aaron Jones has been able to do. They're different type running backs, but I believe that if you get 17 games out of Josh Jacobs versus the 11 that you were hoping to get out of Aaron Jones.
Who are you trying to convince right now?
Me or yourself?
You. No, We did this segment last week.
Yeah.
We said, who would you rather have? Aaron Jones, Derrick Henry, Josh Jacobs. And my vote was Josh Jacobs.
Oh.
I would actually love to see what the poll was from that. I know we have it out here somewhere to see what it was. But when I think about it, the most important thing for this team is you got to have some availability when it comes to your running back position. Think about, rewind to last season. Every week we were thinking, who's going to be at running back? How does that change the game plan? Who's going to be activated? That's a lot to weigh on any given offense. With a younger Josh Jacobs, who, let's be honest, is more durable than Aaron Jones, he's not going to bring the leadership thing from what we know. I don't know much about Josh Jacobs, the guy, the locker room guy. But from an on-field perspective, he will be available. He will run hard. And yeah, our caller is right. They're either going to draft a guy or have Emmanuel Wilson back him up for some extra reps. But you got to have the
That's
same
not a
cast.
Championship team.
No,
I don't want to hear.
Be.
And I'm with you. I don't want to hear Emmanuel Wilson's name at all.
What?
I would like
Emmanuel Wilson.
A lot.
Yeah.
I don't know if you watched the Bears game. That was brutal in the late season. But I think, obviously, from Ricardo's standpoint, I agree. Paying two running backs is risky.
Yeah.
But the only thing I would have said in counter to that is with the cap going up and having a lot of your skill position players locked into these young rookie contracts, the Love domino still has to fall, so we'll see what he gets paid and where that cap money ends up. But this would have been an all-in type move. I mean, you do see success.
What's wrong with that?
Of running backs that, like, where you have two great running backs. The difference is, right, Miami, who had Mostert, and then I'm blanking on the guy who came up, Ashane.
Devon.
Ashane, whatever, right? They're not paying both of those guys as much as they would be paying Josh Jacobs and Aaron Jones. So, look, I'm not going to lie. My Madden brain got a little excited on the idea of Aaron Jones and Josh Jacobs. Looking at it, as he said, taking the emotion out, Ricardo in Canada, I'm very okay with what Goody did.
No, he's completely correct. It is bad business to keep two running backs like that, but I'm just looking at it from Jones is a piece that I felt like this team needed. I trust in this young team, but I still think there's some development that they need to have. In order for the Packers to take the step that they did last year, they needed the veteran presence of a guy like Aaron Jones. My one concern is that the guys on this team are not quite ready to allow for Big Bro, Papa Bear, to move on. I feel like when things get rough and get tough, you had that veteran presence of Aaron Jones that can say something and everybody will listen. I know Jordan Love is the guy. He is the man. But is he ready to assume the role of the sole leader of this team? No more D-Bot, no more Campbell, no more Aaron Jones. It is now Jordan Love's team. Because it ain't Jair's team. It is all about Jordan Love on that offense specifically. We're going to find out what he can do with all that heavy, heavy responsibility.
800-990-3776. 800-990-ESPN. Phone lines open for your reaction. Open to you. Packers sign Josh Jacobs. Release Aaron Jones. Xavier McKinney, who was a target for safety for Goody, signs with the Eagles. So the safety position still out there. We're hoping to see Goody make some moves from that standpoint. 800-990-3776.
Well, Kyle, as you were saying, it is time for Jordan Love to take that step. He showed he can do it on the field. Let's show he can do it in the locker room. Because what's going to happen is, whether quarterbacks want it or not, at the top of their job description is be a leader of the team. That's what they have to do. Because they're the only one that's going to bridge generational gaps as their career goes on. They're the only consistency. Everything else around the quarterback is going to change. The quarterback is something you can build something on. So even if it wasn't this year, it's next year that Aaron Jones is going to be gone. And one more point before I let you go. We started talking about Aaron Jones more about the leader than the guy on the field. That's a red flag to me. You're starting to make excuse for him not being able to stay healthy. He was great when he was healthy, but he wasn't able to be healthy that often.
But his impact that he had at the end of the season was monumental in where this team went. And again, what I think is going to happen is we're going to be in next season and we're going to regret not keeping Aaron Jones. That is the big thing that if some type of presence, some type of issue, I don't know. My gut feeling is that there's going to be some point in the season where we look back and say, man, I wish we had Aaron Jones on this team. And it just feels like it's abrupt. It feels like it's too soon. It feels like this team is not quite ready to move on from him, but they have no choice at this point, man. I'm still holding out hope that they might re-sign him. I don't know what's going to happen.
So
right now, I'm having
issues. He is a free agent. He can go through the process. But my thing is after restructuring twice and signing Josh Jacobs and already getting into negotiation where it didn't end well, it ended to your release, it's hard for me to think that Aaron Jones will be back on the Green Bay Packers.
He's going to be pretty bitter.
Yeah.
Right? And he should be pretty bitter because he did a lot for, he took two straight pay cuts and they probably lowballed him. Let's be honest. They probably lowballed him.
It's what Goody's done.
Yeah.
And that's how you can win a championship.
This is what
the Packers do.
This is the Packers organization.
Yes,
he's 29 years old.
I mean Jordy Nelson would have came back on a pay cut, didn't even offer like anything that he would have even considered because it was like dirt.
It does feel, I will admit, it does feel unceremonious.
To a guy that
like has done a lot, and I'm gonna miss him. I love Aaron Jones. He's got to be, even Jason Wilde said, one of his favorite guys to cover. Just a great guy in the locker room, infectious. They will miss that. Someone's got to step up though. It's got to be Jordan Love.
It's got to be Jordan Love, and it's only gonna be Jordan Love. The other news, like, it's not the other news. There's a lot of news, but some news out of the division is Kirk Cousins is signing with the Atlanta Falcons, and 4 years, $180 million. You know what that is on a per-year annual basis? I know there's guaranteed numbers and whatnot, but it is a baseline. The baseline earlier was Daniel Jones, 4 for $160, $40 million a year. Kirk Cousins, off a torn Achilles, is getting 4 years, $180 million. That is $45 million a year. So if you don't think Aaron Jones and his Aaron Jones, RIP. If you don't think Jordan Love and his camp aren't looking at that and thinking, all right, Goot, cap went up, you really believe in us? Well, hopefully you believe in us more than Kirk.
And Kirk is 35. I mean, this is for the Falcons, this is close to a Band-Aid where it's like, we're going to get Kirk for a few years here, but we still got to think of another plan. When you're a QB1 and this is what a slightly above average as currently constructed coming off a catastrophic injury, gets 45 a year.
This is stupid.
This is insane.
You like that? This is stupid.
Kirk likes that.
No, this is absolutely stupid. The Falcons have been, they are a bad decision after a bad decision. As a Packer fan, I'm just happy because of the fact that I feel good. But this may cost us more money. Well, may cost the Packers more money. This may cost for, what if this is the reason we had to cut Aaron Jones? Because now we got to pay Jordan Love more.
Because the Falcons?
Because of Kirk Cousins. I don't like that.
But think about this as a Packer fan, right? This is what desperate quarterback teams do. And the Packers don't have to be that. The Packer fans should be thankful that they have a quarterback where the problem is
you know what?
They have to pay them.
I want to write this question down. Because if they would have tagged Jordan Love, could they have already given him a deal before all this?
A tag you can keep.
Or a fifth-year option. If they would have gave him his fifth-year option, could they have extended him? Because he's not eligible for an extension because of the contract that they gave him.
I believe with a fifth-year option, there is no limit to continued negotiation. I believe it's like an activation.
But that's what I'm saying.
Contract.
Like it could have happened before the Kirk Cousins to Atlanta.
You could have done it not mid-season, right after the season's
over.
But
you probably could have did it mid-season because they pick up the option. You still have the negotiating power. Because I don't know what year it was for Aaron Rodgers. They must have been. I wonder if they had to pick up his option or not, but they re-signed Aaron Rodgers to an extension during his first season as a quarterback. I think was it after week 8?
Yeah, they did. And the contracts have changed a little bit from CBA to CBA, but you're totally right. Extending the fifth-year option is not a new contract. It's just an extension of your current one, so it allows you to keep negotiating how you want.
Jason Wilde scheduled to appear. Brian Bulaga, former Packer tackle, also scheduled to appear. Josh Jacobs to the Packers, Aaron Jones released, Xavier McKinney, a safety target, signs with the Eagles, Saquon, another running back in that market, which might affect Aaron Jones, went for $12.7 million. A lot of news across the NFL, but affecting the Green Bay Packers. We will hear from you, 800-990-3776. Kyle Brussen-Norman across ESPN Wisconsin. But first, I got to tell you about the Princeton Club, because they have the best facilities in Wisconsin, the cleanest facilities in Wisconsin, and with free childcare with that membership, whew! Think about that. Drop a kid off for 2 hours. I'm going to need that as baby girl keeps getting older. And I'm going to have to continue to further my health. And I've had the courage to go in there. And you just need the courage to get the tour, join. And you'll find your better tomorrow at one of their 8 Madison locations or New Berlin. 800-990-3776. Your reaction to all the stuff across the NFL, but specifically, Josh Jacobs or Aaron Jones, who would you rather had?
You're listening to Kyle Brusten-Nortman, KBN.
And I'm sure he'll offer this opportunity again.
Absolutely
what are you going to sell? What are you going to say to Ben Brusten?
I'm saying, you don't get your hand on my goddamn face. No. It's a no. I can say it in different languages. No, no, no.
Niche or whatever it is.
I don't know.
Nine.
That's a firm way to say no.
Nine. Next time we say nine.
On ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
With your Saganiac Planning Marquette Recap, I'm Ashton Rotman. A back-and-forth battle on the road for Marquette in the regular season finale.
To Chase Ross. Now Gold has it. Hands back to Cam Jones. To Gold. He's got an open three. Good again. Can it be better than Gold? Marquette up 3.
Golden Eagles prevailing in the end, though, behind 30 points from Cam Jones, 86-80, the final over Xavier. Next up, it's Big East Tournament time. Game 1 for the third-seeded Golden Eagles happens Thursday night at 8:30, right here on 94.5 ESPN.
For insurance made simple, look no further than Delta Dental of Wisconsin and Delta Vision. If you want benefits that encourage regular preventative care, savings when you need more than a checkup, quick service, and access to the largest provider networks, who can you rely on? There's one simple answer. Definitely Delta Dental and Delta Vision. Call Eric Pearson, Saganiac Planning, 262-783-6161. Saganiac Planning, a name synonymous with employee benefits and top-notch service.
For over 4 decades, one name has stood out as a symbol of excellence in automotive sales and service. It's the Boucher Automotive Group, dedicated to providing exceptional experiences to all of our valued customers.
We will help you find the perfect vehicle within your budget while respecting your time.
With 20 convenient locations, we're the one-stop destination for all your automotive needs.
At Boucher, we're your trusted partner on every mile of your journey. Riding with you every mile since 1977.
Check out our brand new Hyundai dealership, one of the largest in the Midwest.
Step inside of our state-of-the-art showroom where you can view our new Hyundai models and some of our finest certified pre-owned.
We've also expanded our service center, staffed by our factory-certified technicians.
And right next door, we've started construction on our all-new Genesis of Waukesha dealership.
But we're not just building walls, we're building careers.
So if you're looking for a career with great benefits and opportunity for growth, Boucher is the place for you.
At Boucher, we ride with you every mile.
It all starts next week. We're talking about the Guinness Basketball Hours. This is your chance to enjoy a free pint of Guinness at select locations throughout southeastern Wisconsin.
Beer.
Enjoy the basketball games and a Guinness all month at the Brewery, Trinity, Hooligans, Jack's American Pub, and Nomad. Tune in next week and follow ESPN Milwaukee on social for the exact dates, times, and locations of the Guinness Basketball Hours. Receive free pints of Guinness throughout the tournament with the Guinness Basketball Hours.
Homer here for Higher Love Cannabis Company. 7 convenient locations spread across the Upper Peninsula of Michigan, including Menominee, Norway, and Ironwood. Experiencing the Higher Love difference is easier than ever. Higher Love is your go-to source for organic, clean, green, certified products. Means you can trust them to provide only the good stuff, not the bad stuff. Higher Love for the Menominee location grand opening, March 23rd, an all-day cookout with freebies and more. Visit findhigherlove.com/CBD to learn more and find your nearest location.
Come see Thanalysis live from Potawatomi Casino Hotel on Friday, March 22nd.
Hey, welcome to another Thanalysis show. And who do we have coming up in today's podcast?
Be there for the first ever live show for Thanasis as he's joined by his brother, none other than the Greek freak, Giannis Antetokounmpo.
I took off my shoes and I was like, go crazy, go hoop. That's all it was.
Stay tuned for info. Tickets are on sale soon. Thanalysis live in Potawatomi Casino Hotel on Friday, March 22nd.
ESPN Wisconsin's Mark Tosha here for my friends at Kohler Services. If you need a bath or shower remodel, turn to Kohler Services. Family owned for 150 years. Kohler is your Wisconsin manufacturer providing care for life. This month only, get $1,000 off your Luxstone shower and pay nothing until 2025. Visit KohlerServicesWI.com to request your free quote with fast, professional installation always included. Again, that's KohlerServicesWI.com.
You're listening to Kyle Bruston Nortman, KBN, on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
A weekly pulse on the Milwaukee Bucks, straight from a fan favorite and Bucks legend. Tune in to Hear District with Marcus Johnson, a Bucks Plus audio production. Marcus and his son Chris, a 1995 UCLA champ himself, talk about everything happening in the Bucks world and are joined by some of the biggest names in basketball. Plus, they'll answer your questions too. Stay on the beat of the Bucks and find Hear District now on Bucks.com/plus, the Bucks app, or wherever you get your podcasts.
Just tweeted a link to our YouTube at ESPN Milwaukee, at ESPN Madison. But I will say the hardest part of that was I put a GIF of Aaron Jones doing his first down dance. And I'm really going to miss it because when he did the dance, it was always after everything that he gave the Green Bay Packers. Like he was a great Green Bay Packer. I'm not trying to rub it in, Kyle, because I'm sad. You know how much I loved Aaron Jones. Like he was awesome. Like he was the ultimate teammate. And we know this because Jaden Reed, a rookie wide receiver, second round draft pick, when he didn't have a catch, I believe it was against the Cowboys that he might not have, or
it was against the Cowboys. Jaden Reed did not have a catch whatsoever.
But all we hear from Jaden Reed is a quote about how Aaron Jones made him a better football player. He makes him want to play harder. He makes him want to block. And Jaden Reed tweeted teary eye. So
see, the kids weren't ready.
They weren't ready for Papa Bear to leave the nest.
I'm an emotional mess right now internally. I'm trying to hold it all in. I'm a grown ass man. These kids ain't ready.
Oh, wow.
They are not ready to lose him.
You sound worse than them.
Yeah, no, Kyle feels like he just got dumped by a girlfriend.
This might be worse than that. Yeah.
So the other thing that I remember of Jones from this last season, I think it was the Vikings game when it was the lowest of the low. It was rock bottom in retrospect for this team. Dontavian Wicks walks off the field, head hung low, And, you know, Jones kind of picked his head up, like kind of took his helmet and picked up, looked him right in the eye. And that was one of the things that turned them around. So he is so easy to root for. He is so easy to root for. I'm going to miss rooting for him as someone that I love to see the Packers do well and see him do well. But Kyle, don't you think these are grown men? They're professional football players. If Jordan Love's your QB1, it's time for him to step up and for everyone else to take accountability. They had 1 year with Aaron Jones. They see what a guy that carries the G looks like. And this is just the way of the NFL. It keeps moving. It's painful. It's business. But it's just, don't you think they all need to step up now?
You need to be strategic in building a team. You need to be strategic in relationship development. You need to be strategic on building a foundation of the Green Bay Packers. Aaron Jones was part of the foundation of this team. And yes, he was part of the old guard, but he was an important piece for moving forward for this Green Bay Packers team. And when I think of Aaron Jones, I think about Udonis Haslem that they had at the Miami Heat, right? An old dude that had no business being on the roster. But he served a purpose.
That's not he comparable. Served,
that no, is a
Udonis Haslem was making the vet men and went what? To the
oh,
sitting on. What are you doing, man?
Head coach. No,
I know what you're trying to do.
The presence. I'm saying the
we know his spirit was important.
The importance
but when
of the
you break it down,
presence.
Kyle, he is old. He's been injured. I love him.
I honestly think you're not giving the current players enough credit for like being able to go out there and be professional.
The rookie just tweeted a teary eye over somebody about to make millions somewhere else.
It just means he cares.
It's like, a bummer, for sure.
Yeah, it doesn't mean that Josh Jacobs can't come in and he'll be like, holy cow, this guy's good. I should probably block for him, too.
One note teary eyes for David Bakhtiari. One note teary eyes for Devondre Campbell. I see no teary eyes for them. I'm telling you, this is an important
Keyshawn
piece of
this Nixon's
team.
Keyshawn Nixon's been putting out cryptic, like, eyes emojis and all that.
You don't worry about Keyshawn Nixon. We worry about Aaron Jones right now. I just don't feel like this was the moment to make that move.
Well, a lot of people agree with you because on Twitter at KBNESPN, about 700 votes in, did Packers GM Brian Gutekunst make the right move in signing Josh Jacobs and releasing Aaron Jones? 36% agree with Goody. Now, and I think that's interesting because what happened to last week? Trust in Goody. Everybody's
do you trust him implicitly now?
Everybody's screaming to the high. He himself.
Yep. Let me tell you something about Kyle Wallace. I'm a roller coaster, okay? I'm a roller coaster on this show. I'm a roller coaster in real life. If you think for a second I'm trusting in Goody right now, our relationship is strained. I need a therapist to be over to help me through this because I am not happy with this decision whatsoever. Only because I got a glimpse of what this team could be.
Mad City Brew, back on the Goot hate train. Come on, guys.
No.
But can't we look at this and say, running back, 4 years younger. Let's say you get him for just slightly more than what you'd be able to get Aaron Jones for. Maybe probably more available because he's younger. More you know, freshness in the tank. Don't you think this is a win for the Packers?
No. This is not a we swapped out if during
you're not, there's no convincing
if
today.
During the season we would have said, hey, would you trade Aaron Jones for Josh Jacobs during the season? Would y'all have said yes?
Josh Jacobs was at least out there.
I mean, hamstring and MCL.
Man, like, this is tough. I get it is tough.
I will admit it's tough.
Tell him because you lived it.
I mean, this is the reality of it, and honestly, this is a harsh lesson for these rookies to learn that, like, veterans are going to age out. They're going to get released. The threat's always there. This is a reminder of how hard this business is, and you need to give these young professionals more credit. They can man up, take care of themselves, and make Jordan Love be a leader.
I just hope that in the next 2 hours and 15 minutes that Goody signs a safety so we can see the I trust Goody come out of Kyle.
Can I just say this? Young Bradley Nortman, a kid from Brookfield, Wisconsin. He was in the gym working out. And remember when you saw Steve Smith? You're like, Steve, what's going on? You were
this is at the Carolina Panthers facility.
Yes, yep. You were all impressionable because you were seeing all the stuff in the news. Were you disappointed when you heard that Steve Smith was going to get released?
I was disappointed.
Exactly. It hurt a little bit. Now, imagine being a rookie that actually, you getting your head picked up by him. You telling him, I want to block for you, bro. This is going to, these kids are going to be in mourning. How weird it sounds. They are going to have this moment of like,
you're gonna be in mourning.
Here's what I will say. The long snapper, I know we're not getting a specialist talk, but the long snapper on the Panthers, JJ Jansen, was 4 or 5 years older than me, and he was the man. He was like my best friend in the NFL. If after one season they would have released him, Yeah, I would have been bummed. It would have been harsh. It would have been shocking. But there would have been a certain level of like, I better man up because I'm the dude now. Like, I'm all of a sudden the leader.
I'm a professional.
I'm getting paid for this.
I just led the team in receiving yards and had 10 yards of carry over 100 yards rushing. I can take that step and fill everything that Aaron Jones taught me.
And we can expect them to feel the human emotions now, but if you fast forward 5 months since training camp and they're still feeling bad about it, they need to be professionals.
Josh Jacobs, do know you are replacing a legend.
It is hard to replace a legend.
You are replacing a fan.
But you right
favorite.
Now with this energy are not helping anything.
The expectations are set. Josh, you're replacing a legend. And Josh, what we need from you, we need you to step up and not only be an excellent guy on the football field, but we need you to be part of this brotherhood that has been bonded, that has been created with this Green Bay Packers team. We took so many steps in the right direction by ridding ourselves of the Aaron Rodgers energy, by having D-Bock not even be by the team most of this season. We were going in the right direction and you had the right pieces around. Heck, Jaire Alexander even got set straight. This is just not – the energy, the frequency that our boy Tory Lowe talk about, you can hear Tory Lowe on our show every single Tuesday.
The frequency doesn't matter when it comes to making decisions about football, man. Packer fans letting emotions get in the way because 33 is a great personality and does great in the community. That's RJ in Atlanta. There's so much more to dive into. We will continue to talk Josh Jacobs, Aaron Jones. Xavier McKinney was a safety that the Packers were eyeing. He signs with the Eagles. But another signing that impacts the NFC North, but also Jordan Love, I want to dive a little deeper into Kirk Cousins because he signed for 180. Will Love's deal be higher or lower than an aging Kirk Cousins? Because man, oh man, 4 years, 180, $45 million annually. I was thinking 47.5 to 50 million for Jordan Love. I think he's going to get more. What do you think? 800-990-3776. That's next on Kyle Bruce Norman across ESPN Wisconsin.
The Packers are parting ways with Aaron Jones. React with us. 94.5 ESPN. Football guy.
Good morning, Tausch. How are you?
Football guy.
I'm not feeling 100%.
Coming at it from different views.
I think with all that little stuff going around and the long trip back from the loo, I'm going to grind.
Wildy and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Also sponsored by Coors Light. Weekdays 9 to noon on 94.5 ESPN and available wherever you get your podcasts with Wisconsin On Demand.
The Bucks Bar Network, presented by Michelob Ultra and Bally Sports Wisconsin, boasts the best spots to cheer on the deer when you're not at Fizer Forum. With official Bucks Bar Network locations throughout the entire state, you can catch every single game. Pair the edge of your seat action, freakish plays, and championship-caliber Bucks basketball with a Michelob Ultra. Visit bucks.com/bars to find the Bucks Bar Network location near you.
Get ready to paint the town green this St. Patrick's Day at Revere's Wells Street Tavern in Delafield. Join us for a weekend of fun starting Friday, March 15th with live music by the Old Goat Skipple Band and a Tullamore Dew sampling. On Saturday night, catch the firefighting bagpipers and the O'Brady's, followed by a Jameson sampling. Sunday morning, we're opening at 9 a.m. for Irish breakfast offerings and live music by Killarney Blarney, followed by the Trinity Irish Dancers. Enjoy specials like Reuben sandwiches and Guinness beef stew. Make Revere's Wells Street Tavern your St. Patrick's Day destination. Visit them at reverestavern.com.
We've told you about Moses Adara,
the diamond cutter who created the Kessler 81.
The magical diamond that vibrates with light.
Kessler's works with crazy diamond cutters.
Geniuses who create wonderful, spectacular,
crazy diamond shapes.
The one thing these crazy genius diamonds all have in common
is that they explode with light.
The Kessler Emerald Cut Diamond sends out rippling waves of light, like water lapping onto a beach.
The Kessler Square Radiant Diamond glows like the sun on the horizon.
Sometimes sunrise,
sometimes sunset.
Come to Kessler's.
Come to Kessler's.
Come to Kessler's.
Ask to see the rippling waves of light, like water on the beach.
Ask to see the glow that looks like sunrise and sunset.
Ask to see the Kessler Crazy Genius Diamonds.
See them for yourself.
See them for yourself.
See them for yourself.
To find the Kessler's nearest you, visit KesslersDiamonds.com.
Nelnet Incorporated has document imaging technology from James Imaging Systems, your local business technology partner. Facilities coordinator Sunday Heideman, local and partner ring true for you. Why?
They become your friend. They are easy to work with. You get to know them on a personal level, and they're very outgoing.
James Imaging Systems, helping local businesses do business better.
Being a partner, we can collaborate with each other, and we can make the best needs and outcome for our company.
James Imaging Systems, better technology, great people.
Makes my job so much easier that I can contact the people that know the machines, and I know I'm going to be taken care of.
Sunday, anything to say about James Imaging Systems to others?
They're a great team to work with.
Document imaging technology from James Imaging Systems. Call 262-781-7700. James Imaging Systems, your local business technology partner.
Hi, it's John Reitz from Great Midwest Bank. And as a community bank, we sincerely appreciate our customer loyalty. Over nearly 90 years, we've done all we can to return the favor. Great Midwest Bank offers flexible solutions that bigger banks and credit unions simply can't, because our entire team is right here in the community. We love helping our neighbors when we're at work and then catching up over the weekend. Visit us at greatmidwestbank.com. Great Midwest Bank, your simply local equal housing lender.
The Packers are releasing Aaron Jones.
Share your thoughts here. 94.5 ESPN.
Kyle, Bruston, Norman across ESPN Wisconsin reacting to Aaron Jones being released after failing to come to a great spot with Goody to restructure. But Goody makes a move and signs Josh Jacobs. Now, I did mention Xavier McKinney. A local New York beat writer has it. Before I say he's on the Eagles, I'm going to wait until I see the big dogs throw it out there. How about that? Shefty, Rap, mostly Shefty. You see where I'm going there. Quick, let's go to Diana in Maguanago, 800-990-ESPN. Your thoughts on Aaron Jones being released?
Goody's an idiot, and they're going to pay the price for getting rid of Aaron Jones.
I mean,
oh, wow.
I mean,
that's all I have to say.
That's all you need to say, Diana. Look, like she's like Kyle.
But she's usually optimistic. She's more optimistic than me.
But usually when the reactions on a day of free agency are emotional like this over somebody that's been with your organization for so long, you can't see past what Goody is hired to do. Again, the same people. Last week, I trust in Goody no matter what. The draft picks, the free agency, everyone was mentioning that they trust him. And then now, because you release Aaron Jones, as he's getting older, and the running back market he's not going to go for what, you know, all these guys are going for. You need to have a plan for the future. And when it doesn't seem right, that's usually when it's right.
Well, and what did we say about the Patriots last week and some of these other franchises that have sustained success? They tend to move off a year early as opposed to a year late. Kyle, I agree. This does feel like the Packers moved off a year early. But you just got to trust. If we're going to trust Goody with all these other decisions, which I think I do. I think I trust him. I don't know if it's implicit yet, but I think I trust him. And we need to, you know, upgrade to a younger running back and move off maybe a year earlier. Maybe that causes some pain in the moment. But don't you think it's for the better when we look down the road, maybe even just 2 years?
I just want to win championships. That's all I want to do.
How about
this? And this made me feel like my team was the office with having Josh Jacobs, Aaron Jones, Jordan Love, Jaden Reed, a healthy Christian Watson, trending in the right direction, Tay Wicks, a Romeo Doubs, a Luke Musgraves, a Tucker Cry, like all of these weapons. I just felt so good, Brett. It felt like that office would be unstoppable. I want to win Super Bowl titles, and getting rid of Aaron Jones after signing Josh Jacobs does not make you closer to a Super Bowl title. You basically stayed the same and maybe you lost a little bit based off the spirit of this team.
A lot of callers right now echoing what the poll results are on Twitter at KBN ESPN, agreeing or not agreeing that this was a good move for the Green Bay Packers. signing Josh Jacobs and getting rid of Aaron Jones. Carter in Fitchburg, 800-990-3776.
How you guys doing? Good?
Doing well. Good. Give us your thoughts.
Well, been better.
I'm trying to stay positive here, but I'm just trying to figure out who's got that G, you know, branded on their heart like Aaron did. It's hard to think of who's got that, you know,
I got an
legitimate
idea,
Packer like drive, you know.
I got an idea, and I think you're going to like this. On Sundays, after Kyle Wallace does the Green Bay Game Day pregame show across ESPN Wisconsin and 620 WTMJ here in Wisconsin, we're just going to get him a job as the Packers like cheerleader, like a Packers passion cheer, like to just be
on the sideline.
Just be the side. I just need to be sidelines Aaron Jones. It has nothing to do that your hair looks similar. It has everything to do with your passion for the G. You're a stockholder. You care. You want Jaden Reed to block for the team. You want him to block for Jack. You think you could go talk to the team if you're on the sideline, motivate them to do it for you and everyone else that in Packerland feels like you?
Well, the way I feel right now, I might pull a trail spree wheel.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, man.
Where is he? Oh, wow.
That was funny.
No, I'm serious.
I would love to be the in-house hype man for the Green Bay Packers in order to motivate them. I think I could be a pretty good mentor. Only problem is that
I don't believe right now.
No, I don't believe.
You know what? You're fired. No, you're already fired.
I believe. I'm just, you know, I would be trying to kick it with the players too hard.
Mike and Portage, 800-990-3776. Your thoughts on the Jones release and Jacobs signing?
Well, Jacobs is a good running back, but I think in order for him to have been successful in Green Bay, he needs a complimentary back, and that was going to be Aaron Jones. I really like to see what the difference was in the negotiation of the price. But here in the meantime, we still have A.J. Dillon on the roster, who stinks.
He's not going to be a part of the team. I can promise you that. All right. Thank you, Mike and Portage. A.J. Dillon will not be a part of this team. And complimentary backs. And here's how I want to do this, right? Everyone hates talking about fantasy football, but a lot of us play fantasy football. And what do we do as people who play fantasy football in week one and week two? We go look for the running back that pops. And it happens every single year. And I'm not saying that the Packers are going to, you know, sign the next or draft the next running back that's going to be that guy. But it's very easy to find young talent coming. There's a reason why it's hard to pay these guys at the running back position a lot of money. You know why? Because there's so many of them. And the young ones are, you can just plug and play and boom and boom and boom.
Yeah, you know, hand in the air, I'll admit, when I heard the possibility of Jones and Jacobs, I got a little excited. And then a couple people on our YouTube chat, our group chat, even said that, like, wait a minute, now we're paying two running backs? So I actually admit, paying two running backs, as lethal as that would be on a football field, the game's changed a little bit. And I agree, you do need a complimentary running back. You can't have a running back one take every single carry. You need a third down guy. You need a changeup guy. But the complimentary running back needs to be paid a complimentary salary, which is a fourth-round draft pick, a third-round draft pick. There's just too many other needs. I'm thinking safety. I'm thinking linebacker. I'm thinking O-line. They just need to build a team around. So Josh Jacobs can be your feature back. Awesome. You need another guy, but that's probably where the draft is coming in handy.
And you have 5 picks in the top 100. I think 11 picks overall. You have an opportunity to maybe grab one or two late and see who outduels one for. I mean, I think you're going to see a pass catcher. Josh Jacobs, not a huge pass catching running back, more of a downhill guy. But he did lead the league in rushing yards. A lot of people, 800-990-3776, are afraid that Aaron Jones is going to end up in Dallas.
Yeah, I am too. Very concerned. And then we play him, and then all of a sudden he's smiling and waving to us and our defenders. Oh, I would hurt.
Are you all right?
I'm not.
Because he's Brad, really not okay. We're like having conversation, yeah, and I think he's gathering steady. His thoughts.
Yeah. Well, because this deal was a home run deal to me if you combine the two backs together. Because I look at it from a positive place of, hey, he gets to share carries with a great back, gets to be around this great offense.
But what about what Brad had just said about having two running backs at a high value price.
Listen, sometimes you make sacrifices in order for winning. This could have been a winning sacrifice.
But who does that? Who's winning Super Bowls?
Okay,
you said your goal is to win a Super Bowl.
My goal is to win a Super Bowl, and I feel more confident with Aaron Jones than I do Josh Jacobs. And then now, here, I become more critical of Josh Jacobs in the season he had last year, in a disgruntled year that he had with the Las Vegas Raiders based off him and his contract. Career lows in games played in 13, rushing yards of 805, yards per carry 3.5, and 6 rushing touchdowns.
That was the Raiders, not the Packers,
no,
though.
No,
franchise.
Yeah, they were horrible last year.
He had 1,600 yards the year before with that same horrible franchise. My whole point is
imagine what he can do with Matt LaFleur. You need to spin this more positive. You're letting the emotions of Aaron Jones blind you right now.
We're getting a guy coming off a down year, right? He had a down year. He's young, and he has a lot of great potential. I like Josh Jacobs, but I just don't feel like he is a major upgrade from Aaron Jones. I don't.
Pour one out. But drink your Carb Bliss and tell us why Kyle needs to take a breath. And 800-990-3776. I see your call, see your text. See you on YouTube at ESPN Madison, at ESPN Milwaukee. Continue to react to you, but tell us about Carb Bliss.
Yeah, you know, I would love to because we're just coming off the weekend. It's Monday, and I'm still thinking about when I was cracking open those Carb Blisses and enjoying them oh so smoothly because Carb Bliss has everything I'm looking for in an alcoholic beverage. It's my favorite. It's my go-to. It's all I drink. That's because when it comes to Carb Bliss, man, they think about your health in mind here because I'm always thinking about my health, eating well, working out. But I want to kick back and enjoy a little bit, but I don't want to just detonate everything I did. That's why I grab Carb Bliss. No carbs, no sugar, 100 calories per can, gluten-free, less carbonation. That means the less bloating. So when I drink it, I feel good. I feel like I'm not going backward. Also, the flavors are off the chart. A little bit of fruit flavors for you. It's warm out there today. It's like 60 degrees. I might be starting to dive back into those with like lemon lime and pineapple. But also the classic cocktails like Paloma, Margarita, Moscow Mule. I want you to experience why Carb Bliss is my go-to drink. Experience why Bliss is more. You know what? I think I just convinced myself into wanting a Carb Bliss. I'm going to have another one tonight. And I want you to figure out why less Bliss is more. Find them online and at retailers near you.
We'll be back in 2 minutes. Kyle, you just reacted. What happened? What happened?
Adam Scheffner is reporting. Free agent safety Xavier McKinney is signing a 4-year, $68 million deal with the Green Bay Packers.
Oh!
Back in 2 minutes, Xavier McKinney, woo! Josh Jacobs, you trust duty now?
I don't know what I am.
Back in 2 minutes.
The only thing that tops our selection is your savings discount liquor.
Hi, this is Marie from Discount Liquor, Southeastern Wisconsin's beer, liquor, and wine headquarters. For over 60 years, 7 different decades, all as a local family-owned business. Discount Liquor has a selection with over 14,000 varieties of beer, liquor, and wine in stock, along with everyday low prices, expert service, and convenience with 2 locations. But don't just take my word for it. Let's check out some online reviews. Robert wrote, "There's not a better liquor store around. Nobody even comes close to their beer selection. The only issue? I get brain overload because there are so many choices." And Aubrey recalled, "I went in looking for a very specific and rare dessert wine. They not only knew of it, but special ordered it and called us when it was available for pickup. Just can't beat their service. Thanks, Robert and Aubrey, for your kind words and patronage." Discount Liquor, in Milwaukee on 51st and Oklahoma, and in downtown Waukesha on Main and Barstow.
This is the time of year to enjoy your life. Stop letting that pain in your joints keep you from doing what you want to do this spring. Call QC Kinetics now. QC Kinetics is the nation's leader in regenerative medicine. I'm talking about joint pain relief with no surgery, no drugs, and no downtime. It is a fact. QC Kinetics is literally transforming lives. Their advanced treatments harness your body's own ability to restore and repair that damaged joint tissue. Pro athletes have been doing this for decades, but now this life-changing treatment is available for you. So you can walk and run, climb stairs, play golf, move again, pain-free. No pain pills, no risky surgery. This is an all-natural solution. QC Kinetics has tens of thousands of satisfied patients who have reclaimed their mobility. Take action now. Live your best life this spring and summer. And it's a great use of your tax refund check. Call QC Kinetics for a free consultation. Call 414-285-3474. That's 414-285-3474. 414-285-3474.
Gabe Neitzel here. Catch Jen, Gabe, and Chewy mornings 7 to 9 on 94.5 ESPN, WKTI, and WKTI HD, Milwaukee.
A locally owned Good Karma brand station.
broadcasting live from the Gruber Law Office's One Call That's All studio at the Avenue in downtown Milwaukee. This is Kyle Brusten Nortman, KBN, on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
This is some breaking news.
Kyle said it before we took a break, but it is, per Adam Schefter, a Packers move. Free agent safety Xavier McKinney is signing a four-year, $68 million deal, $17 million a year with the Green Bay Packers.
Woo!
Oh, wow.
Got my boy Xavier.
Oh, wow. He was crying 5 minutes ago.
Let me be a roller coaster. This is what this is all about, right? You gain.
I said today was my favorite day since the birth of my daughter.
But here's the thing. I'm sorry. Just the excitement of the Green Bay Packers are making moves. This is very unusual. We talked about it before.
Very unusual.
You said you wanted Goody to dip in. You want him to dip in a little bit more this year, and that's exactly what they are doing. I'm still upset about losing my boy. Whatever his name was. No, I'm just kidding.
Oh,
Aaron Jones.
I was about to say. I'm just playing.
No, I'm still upset about losing Aaron Jones, but Xavier McKinney is somebody who is what exactly we're looking for this defense. Talk about knees. Talk about fit. This is a great fit for this defense of what Halfley wants to do.
Well, speaking of fits, I do want to hear from Jeff Halfley himself because Xavier McKinney, young, and obviously a very talented safety. You don't get $17 million a year at that position unless you are worth it, and you better be worth it. You said Josh Jacobs, you got a lot of pressure replacing Aaron Jones. I get that. But in terms of what Jeff Halfley needs, this was Jeff Halfley, the Packers' new defensive coordinator, in what he is looking for in a safety.
I want a guy who can erase things. We got to eliminate explosive plays when we play this defense. So if a run hits up the middle, this guy's got to come out of the middle field with his hair on fire. He's got to be able to get a guy down. I also want him to be a guy when a ball carrier's wrapped up, he goes and he finishes off the pile. I want a guy who can go from sideline to sideline and take the ball away. I think that position has to be a guy with high ball production, meaning he's got to be able to intercept the ball. He's got to be a guy that can communicate, and he's got to be a guy that can get guys lined up and make some calls back there. And I'd love a guy who can play man, so I guess I'm describing the perfect player to you. But those are some of the traits that I would look for in playing that position.
He's looking for the perfect safety. And look, the Packers spent money this free agency. So I would even say, even alone in Josh Jacobs and Xavier McKinney, maybe more impactful than what they did in 19, heading into 19 with Za'Darius Smith, Preston Smith, Billy Turner, who was a swing tackle, and Adrian Amos, who was a solid safety.
You just signed two marquee day one big ticket free agents, offense and defense. Not only one that fits Halfley's system. Now let's put it out there. Xavier McKinney's got big shoes to fill. That's what he's expecting for Jeff Halfley. But this was their dude. This was the guy out there who's going to be that safety for them. You know what else this reminds me of? You know what we loved about this team? They were young. They were a young ascending team. This is a young man's game, guys, and you get younger and younger at positions that progressively get older, running back, safety. So this team got younger, they got faster, they got more talented. This team has already experienced upgrades from what they did last season.
And what I like about this is that when you talk about needs, when you talk about building this defense, when you talk about switching from a 4-3 from a 3-4, this is an important piece that you needed to get. And also talking about relationships, the relationship that, you know, maybe that played a role in getting Xavier McKinney here with him, having a relationship with one of our new coaches, Derek Ainsley. That's what I like. I like a guy that made
Jen Latta texted me, host of Jen, Gabe, and Chewy, morning 7 and 9, 94.5 ESPN, Jordan Love and McKinney. They share the same agency.
And so, again,
Jordan Love, powerful.
You need these type of relationships. This is how you build a championship roster. I know it's been a swing of emotions here, and I feel like the Packers still need pieces that they need to put to this puzzle, but this is a big move.
800-990-3776, taking your reaction to everything from the signing of Josh Jacobs to the release of Aaron Jones to Xavier McKinney. $17 million a year at the safety position. Mike in Middleton, 800-990-3776. You are on the opposite end here of what many Packer fans are. What do you got?
Well, first of all, this news about McKinney broke while I've been waiting on hold, and he is the number one target the Packers should have been going after, so I am elated. McKinney is exactly what they need. He's only 25 years old. For Packer fans who don't know,
24.
He played with the Crimson Tide in Alabama. He played in a lot of big games, made a lot of big plays. In New York, he wasn't in the spotlight that much because the Giants stink, and now he should be on what's a better overall defense with the new defensive coordinator. But the reason I called is, if you are not a Packer fan, and I am, and I love Aaron Jones, he's one of my favorite all-time Packers. If you take being a Packer fan out of this, and if you're a fan of any other team, and you say, okay, this morning you're going to wake up and you can have either Josh Jacobs or Aaron Jones on your team for the next season and possibly beyond. We don't know the contract yet, but I'm guessing it's multi-year for Jacobs. Which one are you going to take? Nobody is picking Aaron Jones. Everybody's taking Josh Jacobs. And here's another thing. Josh Jacobs is a bell cow running back. You can give him the ball 25 to 30 times a game, which they did two seasons ago when he led the NFL in rushing. Keep in mind, who were the Raiders quarterbacks last year? Jimmy G and Aiden O'Connell. Not Love, an ascending quarterback who's got threats all over the field now in his young tight ends and wide receivers. This is a home run day for the Packers. Even if they don't sign anybody else in free agency, this team is now prepared to make a serious Super Bowl run.
Mike in Middleton.
Wow.
Bringing the heat. That's some Packer backer action right there, and you don't feel it.
I mean, obviously, I don't feel it in the moment because Aaron Jones is a big piece. There still needs to be moves made, in which I expect Goody to make some moves in order to solidify that offense in that backfield. The Packers are not there in the backfield yet, and he made a great point about, you know, Jacobs being a bell cow, but there's something there that I feel like would still be missing from this roster offensively.
But we can admit that is more like in the locker room,
yes.
Right? So, because we can agree that on the field, Josh Jacobs brings at least, if not more, than what Aaron Jones brings.
The ceiling is more than what Aaron Jones brings, yes. Clearly it's a higher ceiling.
Yeah, but the floor is also more games healthy, played and
younger
and not injured as much. I mean, like, look, I think that, like, Kyle, I'm shocked that, like, even with Xavier McKinney, obviously that was the good news of your day.
Oh, great news.
Aaron Jones, like, I understand your heart is so, I mean, he bought stock. He is a shareholder of the Green Bay Packers. So I know you love them, but you're the same guy who wanted to trust Goody. I'm asking you right now to trust that what he did is right for the Green Bay Packers, because nobody thought it was right in 2020 when they drafted Jordan Love. Nobody thought when Jordan Love was throwing the ball to Davante Adams 15 times when Aaron Rodgers was out with COVID that Goody made the right decision. So there's been many times where you probably have questioned Goody and you told yourself, I'm not going to make the same mistake. I'm asking you not to make the same mistake right now.
It's hard. You're asking somebody who basically got dumped. And I mean, I feel like I got dumped. Got dumped in... blindsided by a decision. That's what it was. Absolutely blindsided by a decision. I still, to this moment, in this moment now, I still do believe this team would be better off with Aaron Jones than without Aaron Jones, and I'm holding out hope that somehow we can bring him back.
All right, we'll move that out of your head, because you're never going to move on. He's going to find a different landing spot. There's value. Aaron Jones has value.
Okay, so what's the next thing? Because you guys, when you look at this roster, the way it's constructed, you don't think that Eric Wilson is the answer. I mean, you joked about...
Emmanuel.
The other Wilson is Eric.
Patrick Taylor already got...
We know that's not the answer. So obviously there's going to be more things that have to be done, because the way that it is constructed now, clearly they need to make more moves and they need to find somebody else that can be a backup to Mr. Josh Jones.
We'll answer that question on the other side, because if you want to talk about how to fill the rest of the roster because you're still so upset and you can't live in the happiness of Josh Jacobs and Xavier McKinney, then that's what we'll do. We'll make you feel better about what the plan is. And you weren't worried about the plan before all of a sudden you had Xavier McKinney and Josh Jacobs. If I would have told you that Josh Jacobs and Xavier McKinney were on the Green Bay Packers last week, you would have taken that in a heartbeat. So remember that. 800-990-3776. What do the Green Bay Packers do next? And I'll tell you what I know they're going to do next. I want to actually bring this back to Jordan Love. Leadership, money, carrying the G. Sometimes it's time to let go. and you got to let go of Aaron Jones. This isn't a funeral, Kyle. He's making me feel like I'm at a funeral. Jordan Love has been on the team for 4 years. Jordan Love will be on the Packers for 5 years. And everyone in the locker room respects him. He led this team to the playoffs. They were 2-5. That's your leader right there. And he's got to take another step because guess what happens when you get paid? You got to take another step there too. So, look. Whew. I'm not feeling his energy right now, especially with what Jordan Love and Goode have shown the last 2 years. He's letting Aaron Jones be released affect the Packers from an overall standpoint. I'm not going to let that happen. We'll be back. Don't go anywhere. Kyle Bruston Nordman.
This is Kyle Bruston Nordman.
Nothing has ever happened to you from a breakup.
I don't want to talk about it.
Oh, no.
I don't want to talk about
it. You brought it, so I had to ask.
I ain't gonna put my old shorties on blast. But
why not? They're old shorties.
Yeah. My parents listen to this show. I don't want my parents to know the craziness that I've dealt with that they son been a part of.
On ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
Eastbound 94 still dealing with an accident in the stadium interchange, so watch out for that. We've also got some backups from about 84th Street all the way through to Mitchell Boulevard. On westbound 894, a little bit heavy from the Loomis area all the way to about 68th Street. Everything else is rolling along fine. And check out the TMJ4 Storm Team forecast today. Mostly sunny, breezy, mild, a high of 62. Tonight, partly cloudy and mild, a low of 46. From the WTMJ Traffic Center, I'm Debbie Lozaga on 94.5 ESPN.
Football guy.
What the hell happened to Bucky on your hat?
Football guy.
A lot of wear and tear for old B.
Coming at it from different views.
I'm just saying, he's well worn. I mean, his face is missing. Okay, well, it's probably time for me to freshen that up. Bucky wants to flip you off right now.
Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Also sponsored by Coors Light. Weekdays 9 to noon on 94.5 ESPN. And available wherever you get your podcasts with Wisconsin On Demand.
There's only one store that gives you every possible choice in diamonds.
Welcome to Kessler's.
Make it a real Mad March with a playoff payout at Pottawatomie. Every week, you could score your share of 100 grand in cash and free play. Play this March for drawing entries. Win each Thursday. Plus, the prizes refresh every week for even more winners. The playoff payout at Pottawatomie, Milwaukee. It's anyone's game. For more details, visit paysbig.com/payout. Must be 21 and a club member to play.
Get in zone, AutoZone.
Welcome to AutoZone. What are you working on today? Brakes? We can save you 15% on that. We have OE quality Duralast brake pads and rotors in stock, ready for pickup or delivery. We also have calipers, brake fluid, tools, and anything else you'll need to do the job right. When you get Duralast pads and rotors together, you'll save 15%. It's just part of what makes us America's number one brakes destination.
Get in zone, AutoZone.
Hear that? The relaxing sound of ambient music in a yoga class. And if you were here, you'd listen to 15 people taking a deep breath in sync. But you're not here. Because your self-care happens out on the road, riding your motorcycle protected by Progressive. So if you ride, get a quote today and see if you could save with Progressive, America's number one motorcycle insurer. And find inner peace with a different pose called Palms on Handlebars. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and affiliates, not available in all states.
Homer here for Higher Love Cannabis Company. 7 convenient locations spread across the Upper Peninsula of Michigan, including Menominee, Norway, and Ironwood. Experiencing the Higher Love difference is easier than ever. Higher Love is your go-to source for organic, clean, green, certified products. It means you can trust them to provide only the good stuff, not the bad stuff. Higher Love for the Menominee location grand opening, March 23rd, an all-day cookout with freebies and more. Visit findhigherlove.com/CBD to learn more and find your nearest location.
Serious truck crash? Call Gruber Law Offices today.
1 in 10 young adults will experience a form of homelessness this year.
For over 50 years, Covenant House has been helping youth in crisis. To learn more, go to covenanthouse.org today.
The Packers are releasing Aaron Jones. Share your thoughts here. 94.5 ESPN.
Girl, if you pull up to my window, I'm gonna take your order, Anything you want, girl, you know I get it for you.
Your reaction to the Green Bay Packers day thus far. Because I tell you what, it's been a while since we've had a day like today for the Green Bay Packers. Legal tampering on a Monday, actually making news on two big guys, like big free agents. Well, I remember what?
Do you think Aaron Rodgers is thinking to himself, like, what is happening here? The minute I leave, the Packers make day one splashes.
Ooh, flag on the play.
I mean, I remember last year. Was it last year or 2 years ago? I don't even remember. It was freezing outside of American Family Field for the home opener. And Sammy Watkins was like, oh, we're bringing in Sammy Watkins. This is like the day one. League year starts on Wednesday. Xavier McKinney from the Giants signs with the Green Bay Packers for $17 million a year annually. Forget the guaranteed. Someone could fill that in for me. And then Josh Jacobs gets signed to the Green Bay Packers. I believe that was 3 years, $24 million. So about $8 million a year. So
that's pretty good.
Yeah, it was pretty good. But also, what does it say about Aaron Jones? Because I think he was probably, they were probably trying to get him around that number, and there's no way you're going to have two guys around that number.
They probably want to get him below that number for sure. Below
exactly. And Aaron Jones, after restructuring for 2 years, said, "Hell with that."
And after taking a step back here, and as I'm still processing the release of Aaron Jones, is that this is still a big day for the Green Bay Packers, a big step forward here for Goody, because this is what the Packers fans, this is what we've been asking for. We've been asking for moves to be made.
Joe in the chat who got to you? Who got to you?
There's been a couple things. I mean, the last caller got to me. I think Joe in the chat got to me. Somebody said,
he said, be a fan of the Packers, not a fan of the player.
And somebody else I saw tweeted out there talking about, thanks for the memories. You know, we're not going to talk about it. And so when I think about this, though, for the Packers in the window, the championship window is open. If this is the Goody that we have, the Goody that's going to be aggressive to fill holes, not just fill holes with average guys such as Hammy Watkins, but actually try to sign dudes that can contribute to this team that are going into their prime, this is what you need to do to build out a roster for a championship piece. And so when I think about next year and beyond, if I think about the Packers, if we don't get to where we want to get next year, what is Goody going to do next offseason or the offseason after that? Is he all in on trying to win a championship? And this might be the first step in a different direction that we have not seen from the Green Bay Packers, because he signed offense and defense this time around.
800-990-3776. Tyler in Portage, welcome into Kyle, Brust, and Ortman across ESPN Wisconsin.
Hey, guys. Thanks for letting me call the show. First, I Kyle, I got to ask you a question here. You know, I'm a big Jones fan too, but at what point do you look at it and go, hey, we just got a heck of a running back. And not only that, but we got rid of Bakhtiari, who I think everyone on the show, like, everyone loves him, but dude hasn't played in 2 years. You saved yourself, you know, $30 million, and we just got two great players. All pro, probably.
Yeah, I'm not crying over D-Bach. I am a little upset about Aaron Jones. It's just a process, man, because when you look at what this team could be, and plus, they sold us a dream. For about an hour or two there, we had this dream of having Jacobs and Jones type team right there. So that is one of the things that you have to process, the fact that you thought this team was going to have a two-headed monster of two really, really good running backs, and then all of a sudden you get rid of one, which is Aaron Jones, and somebody who on the field is a impact. He had five straight games of 100 yards or more and ran his tail off in the playoffs for this Packers football team, and now you're getting rid of him. So the unknown of what Josh Jacobs is going to be in big moments is something Packers fans should be concerned about, should be worried about, should be thinking about, because we knew when the bright lights were on, when we needed something from somebody, we knew Aaron Jones was going to show up for this team on the field, but also the character, the high character that he had, was going to elevate this team off the field as well in the locker room.
Yeah, you know, when I look at this, I totally understand that part of the deal, Kyle, because as a guy that was in a locker room at one point, I got to experience what a great leader is like in a lot of different guys. And when that is left, there is a void. remaining. I totally agree with that. But if we're just trying to be like, is this Packer team better than they were this morning? It's a simple math equation to me. It was, you know, subtract D-Bock, subtract Campbell, subtract Jones, add McKinney, add Josh Jacobs. That equals to me a better Packer team, because those guys on an annual basis is about 25 a year that you've added on, and you've dropped off the other 335.
And so, you weren't having, of two of those three guys, actually you could say three of those three guys for the Packers, Devondre Campbell ended up saying, I'm not going to play unless I'm fully healthy. So he missed some time because of injury. Obviously, D-Bock missed a lot of time because of injury. And Aaron Jones, who we love, had a hamstring injury in week one, and he sprained his MCL, and God bless his soul, he loved the Green Bay Packers so much, and you should appreciate him because he battled back and had three straight 100-yard games, which I believe obviously helped Jordan Love against the Bears, against the Cowboys, and I mean, you can say even, I think it might have been the Vikings that he also had a 100-yard rushing game.
Right.
But regardless, my point is he was big. But I'm going to keep reiterating. We talked about it last week, brought it up. If you think you what's the Belichick thing that I say?
Move off a guy a year too early, not a year too late.
Boom. And this could be that situation, as much as it may hurt your heart. 800-990-ESPN. Now, I do want to talk a little bit about the fact that Kirk Cousins made $180 million over 4 years. Chris, let's put it on Twitter at KBNESPN. Do you expect Jordan Love's contract to be more or less than Kirk Cousins to the Atlanta Falcons?
Oof, way more. I think it's going to be way more. I mean, they're not even comparable guys. The thing that benefits Kirk Cousins is you will likely elicit more money when you are in free agency. Usually when you are signing an extension, you're leaving some money on the table compared to going all the way to free agency. But guys, Jordan Love versus Kirk Cousins coming off an ACL, 35 versus 25. I mean, it's a huge difference. I think Jordan Love, he's proven he's the guy. He's going to get north of 50. I think he is more than 50 now. Just like that.
I mean, if there was any hesitation before of anybody thinking that Jordan Love wasn't going to get $50 million, especially after that playoff performance, especially after Week 10, what he did, there's no question whatsoever. Jordan Love is easily a $50 million man. Easy.
$50
million? $50
million? You think got Chelsea Clinton? For Jordan Love, like, again, we've talked a lot of these angles. I like the way that Brad broke down the math equation. Devondre Campbell, David Bakhtiari, Aaron Jones. Add Xavier McKinney. I don't think we understand the impact. The Packers' safeties were dog water last year. Dog, Jonathan Owens, thanks for coming.
Hold on now, we like Simone.
Didn't say anything bad about Simone, did I?
She ain't dog water.
Rudy Ford?
Yeah.
See you later. Right? Like, this is an opportunity for Jeff Hafley. I mean, and one of the biggest criticisms that I've had of the silo situation that the Green Bay Packers have from a front office standpoint and the relationship between Goody and Matt LaFleur is Goody drafts on measurables, right? And sometimes that's not exactly what you need from a position, from a guy. Hafley said he needed a safety. He got him a safety. He got him an all-pro caliber safety. And that to me is huge, because a lot of times it's, you know, Goody's just going to do the draft and LaFleur's got to put the piece of the puzzle together. This felt like he signed somebody that fit the need of what they needed, not just, oh, we need a safety. I'm going to draft a safety for the future. I'm just going to sign a safety. They got a guy that fits what they're looking for.
Well, I know we got Jason Wildenkamp coming up here soon, but this is one thing that we touched on last week that I know current Green Bay Packer players are feeling. Think about the messaging that Goody is sending this team right now. I'm going to make a splash. Our window is wide open. That we have every reason to be optimistic. When these guys come back in April to, you know, week one OTAs, which is usually just like a show up and do your thing, there's going to be a heightened level of excitement when Josh Jacobs, Xavier McKinney, whoever else walks in the building, and they say, guys, we're surrounding you with studs. Now go do it.
But not only that, what you talked about when guys were signed to the Panthers and the Jaguars in your career, I think they'll just be like heightened like confidence, right? Like even more so than like the this is what we're doing for you. I think it's going to be like, all right, we mean business, right? Like
100%.
We mean business this year.
Yeah, I mean, you fired Joe Barry. That was something that sent a message because everybody was expecting it. You had tension in the locker room. You cut Devondre Campbell, who probably in the locker room they probably liked, but then again, they knew he was old. You talk about knowing about business, the Packers going and signing a guy like Xavier McKinney, I think it's even bigger than that. I think you're going to be seeing even draft for needs because they understand they need to fit, they need to fill some holes on defense in order for this defense to be successful. So don't be surprised. This is a defense-heavy draft here that we got coming up here next month.
I wouldn't be. I mean, the first round's probably going to be defense. Is all good
I guess
does.
Based off his history.
Now, yes. Jason Wilde will be joining us next. He's all Packers all the time and really excited to get his reaction to all the moves that Goody has made. But if you really like what Goody's doing right now, head on over to Pottawatomie Sportsbook. I love jetting over there for some action and cashing in a ticket, which I haven't done in too long. I'm getting there. But it almost makes me as happy as this day today. This day has been phenomenal. I mean, when you have everything breaking and it's going around your team and you get excited about the moves you're making, well, maybe before those odds shoot down to win a Super Bowl, go to Pottawatomie Sportsbook. Bet big, bet bold. There's going to be a 2,000-square-foot video wall with luxury seating for over 200 for the first week of May when they have their grand opening for the state-of-the-art retail sportsbook. It's going to be freaking amazing. So make sure you get to Pottawatomie Sportsbook. Grand opening, first week of May. Mark your calendars. Paysbig.com, paysbig.com. Jason Wilde joins us next on Kyle Brust and Orban across ESPN Wisconsin.
$50 million? And who do you think you kidnapped, Chelsea Clinton?
This is Kyle Brusten Nortman, KBN.
And make sure everyone's tuning in when we do this, because y'all's faces are going to be like,
it better be sweet.
If you think I'm going to act like that for oatmeal, you're outside your damn
You've
mind.
Never had Brad Nortman's oatmeal.
It's not Quaker, is it?
Yeah, but I've also had chocolate chip pancakes with butter organic. And syrup that make me go, oh, baby, oatmeal ain't going to do that.
You'll be surprised. I'm going to do a variety.
On ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
Things are moving along pretty well on the eastbound side of 94 right now. Just a quick tap of the brakes through the stadium interchange. Westbound's a little bit heavier from about 27th Street all the way through to about Mitchell Boulevard. Rest of the system is actually moving along pretty well. No other incidents up on the board. Traffic is brought to you by the Neal Group. They know how to minimize your taxes to keep more money in your pocket. Visit nealgroup.net. That's NEAL group.net. And checking the TMJ4 Storm Team forecast tonight. Partly cloudy skies, mild with a low of 46. Tomorrow, areas of high clouds, breezy, warm with a high of 66. From the WTMJ Traffic Center, I'm Debbie Lozaga, 94.5 ESPN.
Weather is brought to you by Good Health Saunas. Get your in-home infrared sauna today. Great for post-workout detoxing, skin rejuvenation, back relief, and flexibility. Plus, more energy from better sleep. GoodHealthSaunas.com.
ESPN Wisconsin's Mark Tauscher here, and there is one thing I think everyone can agree on. Potholes stink. And this year's weather will make it one of the worst years yet. Well, Johnson & Sons Paving is ready to take on the challenge with a team that has over two decades of experience. When the potholes pop up in your asphalt, Johnson & Sons Paving can patch or replace the whole area. Book an appointment now at johnsonandsonspaving.com. Get that appointment booked before May 31st, and you might even see old T on the job site for a visit. Find full contest details at ESPNWisconsinContest.com.
Your bathroom is boring and basic too. It seems like there's nothing you can do. A better bath awaits. You'll feel brand new, relaxing in a world of peace at the Bath Authority.
Hey, it's Kyle Wallace. Right now, schedule your free in-home estimate and get $1,000 off a new shower or bath, plus 36 months of interest-free financing. Restrictions apply. A better bath awaits.
You're our priority at the Bath Authority.
With your Saganiac Planning Marquette Recap, I'm Ashton Rotman. A back-and-forth battle on the road for Marquette in the regular season finale.
To Chase Ross. Now Gold has it. Hands back to Cam Jones. To Gold. He's got an open three. Good again. Can it be better than Gold? Marquette up three.
Golden Eagles prevailing in the end, though, behind 30 points from Cam Jones, 86-80 the final over Xavier. Next up, it's Big East Tournament time. Game one for the third-seeded Golden Eagles happens Thursday night at 8:30 right here on 94.5 ESPN.
Help protect your team with slam dunk coverage. Seganiac Planning can coach you on ways to save money on medical and specialty plans through United Healthcare, which is one of the largest provider networks in Wisconsin. Call John Seganiac Jr., 262-783-6161. That's John Jr., 262-783-6161. Seganiac Planning, a name synonymous with employee benefits and top-notch service. Insurance coverage provided by or through United Healthcare Insurance Company or its affiliates. Administrative services provided by United Healthcare Services, Inc. or its affiliates. Health plan coverage provided by or through United Healthcare of Wisconsin, Inc.
Don't put your life on hold to earn a degree. Lakeland University has a long history of making students' dreams come true since 1862. Build a schedule that meets your needs with options for 7 and 12-week courses, evening classes, and the ability to join classes remotely. Lakeland University is Wisconsin's leader in evening and online education. They have a main campus in Sheboygan County and 6 centers throughout the whole state. Lakeland University, affordable, quality, flexible. Find out your next steps at info.lakeland.edu.
The Bucks Bar Network, presented by Michelob Ultra and Bally Sports Wisconsin, boasts the best spots to cheer on the deer when you're not at Fiserv Forum. With official Bucks Bar Network locations throughout the entire state, you can catch every single game. Pair the edge of your seat action, freakish plays, and championship caliber Bucks basketball with a Michelob Ultra. Visit Bucks.com/bars to find the Bucks Bar Network location near you.
You're listening to Kyle, Brust, and Nortman on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
Tell me now, do you want it? Because these dancing feet don't cry.
Joining us now across ESPN Wisconsin, I'm Kyle, Brust, and Nortman, is Jason Wilde. You can hear Jason Monday through Friday on Wilde and Tausch from 9 to noon. I'm Ben Brust alongside Packer backer going through all the emotions, Kyle Wallace, longtime NFL punter Brad Nortman. Jason, welcome into the show.
Ben, I didn't know if I was supposed to speak in that long pause. So is Kyle okay? I'm worried about Kyle.
He's coming around. He was in his emotions about Aaron Jones. He still didn't think that like Josh Jacobs things make sense. But Xavier McKinney has put him to, I would say, a 7 out of 10 on the happy sad scale.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, Jason, I just feel like we're ignoring something here, which is Josh Jacobs had a down year last year, right? He had a season that I don't think he played.
Aaron Jones was hurt.
Yeah, Aaron Jones was hurt, but
hamstring, MCL.
Give me the guy I know versus the guy I don't.
Yeah, I first of all, he was really good in 2022. He's 3 years younger than Aaron Jones. He was the NFL's leading rusher and had over 2,000 combined yards during the 2022 season. They fired their coach midway through the year. Their team was a complete train wreck. He missed the last 4 games with a quadriceps injury. So I don't think, of all the things that happened today, I don't think their signing Josh Jacobs is the most, you know, nonsensical or disappointing or riskiest thing they're doing. Like we haven't seen the numbers yet, but I would think that he will be a reasonable bargain. If Saquon Barkley's deal averages a little over $10 million, right, $10 to $11 million. And Tony Pollard's deal only averages $8 million. Swift's deal with the Bears only averages about $8 million a year. So I'm guessing that Josh Jacobs, I don't know, maybe around $9 million. That's a guess. I haven't seen numbers from anybody, but if you look at what they've done, you know, they've gotten the safety, which is so important to what they want to do, defensively. They traded out a veteran who everyone loves, who finished the season on an extremely strong note, but did deal with some injuries last season, replaced him with another very much viable veteran back, as opposed to bringing back A.J. Dillon and drafting someone. You know, they let a couple of guys go that we expected them to watch walk out the door, and they turned the left tackle job over to a third, soon to be third year guy who played the position last year and said goodbye to a stalwart who went to five all pro teams. I mean, it's been a wild day, but I mean, getting McKinney is a pretty big deal. And they didn't exactly pay low cost for him though. But I don't know. I mean, to me, the biggest stunner is that Brian Gutekunst told us that Aaron Jones would absolutely be back, and he's not. I mean, that's the only thing that happened today that I'm like really, really blown away by. I thought there was a chance they were going to sign Josh Jacobs and keep Aaron Jones and have one hell of a 1-2 punch at running back.
Well, we did the first 10-12 minutes of the show very excited talking about that 1-2 punch.
Yeah, and I mean, I guess I know it's been suggested that if Aaron Jones doesn't find what he's looking for on the free agent market, that he could conceivably come back. But
don't do that, Jay. Don't do that to me, Jason.
He's not going
to
say that. I'm with Jason.
I don't.
He said conceivably come back.
It'd be too hard at this point.
I wouldn't. I can't. I mean, even as much as he loves the Packers and he has a Packers G logo tattooed to his knee, I just not even the great Aaron Jones, one of the kindest, nicest people in football, can be released and say, yeah, no, I'll come back for a lot less money. I'll swallow my pride and do that. I think he deserved better. And I think if I'm him, after what I did down the stretch last season, I'm going to go find somewhere else to land.
Jason, we asked, well, I'm not sure if it was last week or the week before, but it was a hypothetical at that point where, you know, the biggest thing we're talking about with Aaron Jones is that leadership void now that's going to be created. And I think we asked at the time is, you know, who's the next to step up? And I think your answer at the time was, I'm not sure there is anybody ready to step up. Well, now that there is that void, who would you place a bet on to be that guy that can step into that role and be that vocal leader to replace Aaron Jones?
That's a great question. I don't know. I really don't. I don't think that they have that many guys that are really ready made for that. I mean, you know, look, Goody is clearly a believer in it's a young man's game. And, you know, Preston Smith is back, I guess. But on offense, like, who does this leave? You literally said goodbye to an 11-year veteran and a 7-year veteran in the same day. They're not going to re-sign Josiah DeGuara. And frankly, even if they did, you know, I don't think he's an important enough piece to be deserving of that high of a level of regard like Aaron Jones had. So, I mean, I guess Elgton Jenkins, I guess Josh Myers, you know, Zach Tom's a really quiet guy, so I don't see him stepping into that void. I mean, you know, you tell me, you're the one who played in the NFL. I mean, I always thought that player leadership was extremely vital, but it sure seems to me that it's a very, very, very secondary or tertiary thing to this organization at this point. Like, they just want as much as young talent as they can find, and, you know, as Jordan Love develops as their starting quarterback and becomes the leader that he's on his way to becoming, they're just going to let him kind of be the guy, and they don't really necessarily feel like they need to keep older guys around to fill that role.
Well, real quick before I jump to another guy's question, you're totally right. I mean, player leadership is essential. It's vital. There are certain connections and leadership qualities that players can exhibit that coaches can't. So it's critical. They got to have somebody step up. And to me, if they're going to pay Jordan Love QB1 money, that's part of the job description. So that's just my insight. I don't know who's up next.
Jason, you just sound so unsure. I mean,
that's a weird way to talk.
Just coming, hearing you, you sound so unsure about the future of the leadership of this team, this organization, and it doesn't make me feel too comfortable. So my big question for you, Jason, is, so what's next? Like, what should we expect next from this Green Bay Packers football team? Goody making these...
Why do you sound like you're dying? They got Josh Jacobs and Xavier McKinney.
I'm excited, but Jason, even when we talk about leadership, leadership is something that is so important for a young football team. Jason said it himself. He does not believe that this team is ready. He doesn't see anybody... stepping into that role that Aaron Jones had. That is a big
no. Now wait a minute. Wait a minute. All right. First of all, take a deep breath. Remember how excited you were during the second half of the season as everything came together. First of all, right? That did not just get erased just because of what happened on the first day of free agency. Secondly, I don't see anyone who is clear cut that can step into that void, but the voids always get filled, right? Like, you know, Ben, you played on Badger teams that different guys rose up to become leaders. That happens on every team.
We went to the Final Four as a senior, and they got better the next year when I left.
Well, sometimes addition is by subtraction, my friend. But the idea that they're not going to fill that void, I'm not saying they're not going to fill it. I'm just saying that there's no one that is the obvious choice. Like, you know, their most experienced wide receivers now at this point are Christian Watson, who missed most of the season with hamstring issues, and Romeo Doubs, who's not that style of a personality. So maybe it's Jaden Reed as a second-year guy who steps into that role, right? Maybe Josh Jacobs comes in and hits the ground running and can do that. Like, I don't think they're going to have a leadership void. My point is that they don't have anyone who is ready-made to step in. Right? Like, you know, it's not like they had a guy who was really, truly ready to step in 2012 when they moved on from Charles Woodson. Like, replacing Charles Woodson is basically impossible, both as a player and as a leader. No one's voice carried the way Charles's did. So, look, I don't think you should be down in the dumps. I think, you know, we know what Bakhtiari's been through. That move did not surprise any of us. I don't think anybody's surprised that they moved on or allowed to leave both John Runyon and Darnell Savage. I was mildly surprised they signed Josh Jacobs, but after what Goody had said at the scouting combine, I thought he was a possibility to go along with Aaron Jones. I did not expect them not to be able to work something out with Aaron Jones. So if you want to be sad about something, that would be it. But they did replace him with Josh Jacobs, who won the rushing title just 2 years ago.
And I know, so I don't like cutting you off, Jason, but I do have the details that just came out while you were speaking. 4 years, $48 million, 12.5 guaranteed.
Dang!
It's expensive.
But I guess there's not a lot of guarantees, right?
But 12 a year, though. I mean, but yeah, that's right. It's not much guaranteed.
Maybe it makes a little more, sense why Aaron Jones wouldn't be back, right?
What's your reaction to that, Jason?
4 years, $48 million is what they signed Aaron Jones to, that he was going into the final year of the deal on, right? And only $12.5 million guaranteed is less than the, I believe, $13 million that Aaron Jones was due to be paid. So, look, again, my issue with, and it's not even an issue, they have to do what's right. I do think that this is, you know, there is reason to wonder how this will impact their locker room. But the only issue that I have is the surprising way that Brian Gutekunst, and I remember telling you guys this the day it happened, like, GMs never talk the way he did about Aaron Jones and using the word absolutely when saying he'd be back. Like, I don't think any GM that I've covered has talked in such clear-cut terms. He always, well, we'll see what happens and whatever. And then for this to reach the point it did with Aaron Jones, I think that, you know, I don't want to speak for Kyle, but that is the one thing that happened today where you're like, huh, that doesn't make a whole lot of sense. I really did. I thought they would figure out a way, you know, to make Aaron Jones whole with his pay, probably by extending him, giving him some guaranteed money, and then spreading that out. So if they decide to move on from a year from now, they could without painful salary cap ramifications. And instead, it's Josh Jacobs replacing him as opposed to working in tandem with him. But everything else, like, we knew that Xavier McKinney was one of their biggest targets, and they landed him, even though the Giants wanted him back, and even though the Eagles were also interested in him. So, you know, to me, that's a big get, especially at a position where the new defensive coordinator was very clear how important that is.
Well, Jason, we appreciate the time, especially on a crazy day like today. Look forward to hearing yours and Tausch's reaction tomorrow, 9 to noon.
All right, guys. Take care. Be good.
Jason Wilde of Wilde and Tausch. Hear him tomorrow on ESPN Wisconsin with Mark Tauscher. Brad, Tausch talks about Gina Della from Pella. You can talk about Gina Della from Pella, too.
Gina Della from Pella, guys, she's a day one free agent. I mean, she is elite. She represents Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin, which are elite. They're our favorite. I know I love them. And guess what? If you're thinking about, is now the time to replace my windows and doors? I don't know. This is the sign that yes, it is. Because it revitalizes the look of your home. Right now, during the springtime, it gets warm, it gets cold, it gets warm, it gets cold. It's going to protect your house from all the bugs and all the pollen, everything coming in there. It's going to increase the value of your home and lower your energy costs. There are so many reasons to contact Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin today. But how about this reason? Right now, up until March 31st, you get 0% interest for up to 3 years. That's right, 3 years of 0% interest at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. You get your Pella today. You get to pay later for 3 years, that is. Order by March 31st to get 0% interest for up to 3 years. Set your free consultation today at PellaWI.com.
You're listening to Kyle Brust and Nortman, KBN.
Ben, I've been a fan of you since Scalzo and Brust is on the air. You kind of are like a Pat McAfee for the ESPN Milwaukee. You kind of revolutionized this channel and stuff.
Leo, I'm here for you, and I appreciate everything you say. We love you listening. And you can call in every day and say that. I won't get old.
On ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com. The Packers are releasing Aaron Jones. Share your thoughts here, 94.5 ESPN. Keep the good times rolling every Sunday with GKB founder and CEO Craig Karmazin on Sunday Karma.
Everyone's using Daniel Jones as why Jordan Love's going to get paid all that money. I think it's the opposite. I think it's what you just hit.
Right.
I think that it's more of like, hey, be careful. Don't just jump into paying someone unless you're sure.
Sunday Karma with Craig Karmazin.
Is that how you manage?
That is not how you manage, but that might be the way that the Green Bay Packers organization goes about their business.
It's the way the Green
Actually,
Bay Packers...
Actually, we know they go about their business like that.
Sundays from 10 to noon on ESPN Wisconsin.
Hey, it's Gabe Neitzel from Jen, Gabe, and Chewy. You've heard me talk about the results mentality has had on my life, but don't just take it from me. Jason has had success too, thanks to mentality.
My only regret is I didn't do it sooner. Knowing once again I've gotten the treatments done and continuing, I do feel, you know, stuff does hurt a little bit more, but I'm 40, you know, in my 40s, and that's going to happen. But again, the energy levels, it is above and beyond. Again, I'm back in that age where I'm like, this is amazing.
Get started today at LowTUSA.com.
Be greeted by an owner at America's largest employee-owned jewelry store.
Welcome to Kessler's.
This is ESPN Wisconsin's Brad Nortman, here to tell you about my favorite go-to drink. That's Carbliss. Carbliss is a ready-to-drink, handcrafted vodka and tequila cocktail. Even better, it's zero carbs, zero sugar, zero gluten, and just 100 calories. And listen to this, less carbonation. This leads to less bloat. I can indulge in something delicious without having that health guilt. Carbliss is crafted right here in Wisconsin. It has a flavor for everyone, from black raspberry to cranberry, pineapple and lemon, and my favorite, margarita. Find Carbliss online and at a retailer near you. Less is more.
For over four decades, one name has stood out as a symbol of excellence in automotive sales and service. It's the Boucher Automotive Group, dedicated to providing exceptional experiences to all of our valued customers.
We will help you find the perfect vehicle within your budget while respecting your time.
With 20 convenient locations, we're the one-stop destination for all your automotive needs.
At Boucher, we're your trusted partner on every mile of your journey. Riding with you every mile since 1977. The Boucher Group has exciting news to share with you. We've expanded to better serve our community.
Introducing Nissan Lake Country, the newest addition to our family.
Step into our showroom and discover our exceptional selection of brand new Nissans.
We are also stocked with the best pre-owned options in the market.
And as we expand, we're not just growing our inventory, we're also growing our team.
So join a team that values your skills and celebrates your success.
Visit us online or in-store today and view our current job listings at BoucherCareers.com.
Getting up to 5% back is easy at Fleet Farm. Fleet Rewards members can earn up to 5% back on every purchase, in-store and online. the earnings stack up automatically. The more you buy, the more you earn. No rebates, no coupons, no hassles. And Fleet Rewards membership is easy, so sign up now and start earning up to 5% back on everything you need for everyday life at Fleet Farm. Some exclusions apply.
You're back at the gym. Your new gym outfit? On point. Your new sneakers? Baller. You've got this. Just like Associated Bank's got you with Access Checking. It's maintenance fee free with no minimum balance requirements. So when you take your first yoga class in 10 months, your body might surprise you, but your checking account won't. You've got this with Access Checking from Associated Bank. See associatedbank.com/checking or ask a banker for details. Member FDIC.
Earth Justice is a national legal nonprofit defending the environment and people's health. Until justice stands for all, our lawyers will never rest. More at earthjustice.org/neverrest. Earth Justice, because the earth needs a good lawyer.
This is Kyle Brustin Nortman on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
See, I like to call Palermo's the victory pizza. And I think it's a victory today. I'm not going to let Kyle and his emotions bring down the fact that, look, you signed a younger running back, you brought in Xavier McKinney, and it's all net positive to me when you think about what you cut and what you brought in. You still have five picks in the top 100. Let's not forget that. I'm feeling good. So the victory pizza for today is Screamin' Sicilian. Palermo's Pizzas is always delicious, but they have tons of toppings on the Screamin'. They have whole milk mozzarella, secret tomato recipe sauce, and they have thin and crispy, which is that cracker-style crust. You have the tavern style as well. 2.5 feet of stuffed crust cheese and the I'm Stuffed stuffed crust pizza, and the OG Screamin's, the holy pepperoni, the Bessie's Revenge, which is the cheese, the Boss Hog, Supremus Maximus, Ultimate Deluxe, the Mambo Italiano.
Mumbo!
Find your screaming pleasure in your local grocer's freezer. On Twitter at KB at ESPN, over 1,000 votes in. Did the Packers GM Brian Gutekunst make the right move in signing Josh Jacobs and releasing Aaron Jones? 38.7 say yes, 61.3 say no. But what I did notice is, as Xavier McKinney has been signed, the happiness and the willingness to accept that it might have been the right move has gone up on the S side.
It's just a shift, right? There is definitely a shift. I think as that move happened, but then also you have time to really digest the move. Because, again, nobody was expecting for him to get released. We were all talking about the two-headed monster, and then boom, he's gone, he's released. No more Aaron Jones. So I think we need time to process and digest this. And I think 24 hours once the cycle comes through, you will see more people like myself probably a little bit more positive about the move.
800-990-3776. Justin the 262. Kyle needs to grow up. We sign top players in their positions of need. Go Pack Go. Goody, I trust.
Wow.
Ken and Oak Creek, welcome into Kyle Brustin Nortman.
Hey, guys. Thanks for taking my call. Hey, it's a great day to be a Packer fan. I think there's two good moves, but two good moves yet to make. To make it an awesome, awesome free agency period. Sign Simmons from Denver. Go after him and go after Patrick Queen from Baltimore. Then it'll be called a grand slam.
That would be called no salary. That would be called no salary cap in the NFL.
That's called Madden. Change the position so he's worse in rating in signing.
I mean, that'd be fun, but it ain't happening.
That would be crazy. Guys, look at this. I just wanted to go through the Packers' offensive depth chart. Outside of Elgton Jenkins, I believe the oldest player on the offense starting is Josh Jacobs.
Ooh!
At 26. Everyone is 23 to 25.
Speed kills.
Wow.
Speed kills.
Youth movement.
You know what
baby?
I don't like? You know what I've been hating on? They're just too old. Old. Like, if you're getting old, I want you gone. Aaron Jones, but he's old.
Veteran leadership. Yeah, you. Where's your mentor at? If your mentor got just acts like that, you'd be upset, man.
Kyle's going to emotionally shift when he sees how cheap Geno Stone went. Go look that up. Let's see if he emotionally shifts. Religion Hamilton up next in Madison from 4 to 6. We're on 94.5 ESPN and on YouTube at ESPN Milwaukee till 5 o'clock leading into the Homer Hour. Josh Jacobs, release Aaron Jones, Xavier McKinney all next in 2 minutes. Sell out.
with me. Oh, yeah. Sell out.
We're moving along relatively well right now. A little heavy westbound 94 coming out of the Marquette, heading out towards Mitchell Boulevard, so heads up with that. Southbound on 41, slowing from Silver Spring down past Capitol Drive. Also got some heavy pockets of heavy traffic. Southbound 43, just south of North Avenue, down through the Marquette interchange. Northbound side starting to slow down right around Fond du Lac Avenue all the way up to about Locust. Traffic is brought to you by James Imaging Systems, your local document imaging partner. Visit jamesimaging.com. And check in the TMJ4 Storm Team forecast. Tonight, partly cloudy, breezy, mild, a low of 48. Tomorrow, partly cloudy, windy, and warm, a high of 68. Weather's brought to you by Fifth Third Bank. Custom solutions built around your goals. Member FDIC. From the WTMJ Traffic Center, I'm Debbie Lozaga, 94.5 ESPN.
That to-do list you have needs one more thing. Chill. It's an easy thing to do. Just crack open an ice-cold Coors Light and chill. Take the afternoon off and binge-watch anything. Go to happy hour and stay for a couple hours. Who's counting anyways? Or hang out with just your dog because you've had enough human interaction this week. Whatever you do, do it with a Coors Light. Mountain Cold Refreshment made to chill. 2020 Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. Celebrate responsibly.
Homer here for Higher Love Cannabis Company. 7 convenient locations spread across the Upper Peninsula of Michigan, including Menominee, Norway, and Ironwood. Experiencing the Higher Love difference is easier than ever. Higher Love is your go-to source for organic, clean, green, certified products. It means you can trust them to provide only the good stuff, not the bad stuff. Higher Love for the Menominee location grand opening, March 23rd, an all-day cookout with freebies and more. Visit findhigherlove.com/CBD to learn more and find your nearest location.
Hey, this is Homer. You're listening to the home of Marquette basketball. 94.5 ESPN is WKTI and WKTI HD Milwaukee.
A locally owned Good Karma brand station.
Broadcasting live from the Gruber Law Office's One Call That's All studio at the Avenue in downtown Milwaukee. This is Kyle Brustin Nortman, KBN, on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
We the boys.
It's the 414 hour at Faux on KBN.
Yeah, it's the 414 hour at Faux that needs to be more energetic, that needs to be happier. I don't want to go through the emotional roller coaster I went through the first 2 hours, but you can find anything from our show at WisconsinOnDemand.com or wherever you get your podcasts. We're streaming live on YouTube at ESPN Milwaukee, 800-990-3776. I'm Ben Brust. That was Kyle Wallace, and alongside me as well as Brad Nortman with Chris Larson running the show. The news of the day, for those who somehow may have missed it, Josh Jacobs, former league leader in rushing yards in 2022, signs with the Green Bay Packers 4 years, $48 million. That's a little more pricey than I would have expected. Because, you know, Saquon's somewhat close to that. And if I could choose between those two, I think there's a gap between those two personally. But regardless, I like the move. He's younger. Now, if you want to be emotional, I get it. Be emotional. Aaron Jones, amazing Packer. He's done everything but bleed green and gold. On the field, off the field, give it his all. Injured, try and come back. Injured, try and come back. Injured, come back. 100-yard rush, 100-yard rush, 100-yard rush. Late last year. At 29 years old. He's turning 30. And it sucks because he means a lot to the team. But I'm telling you, Josh Jacobs with Xavier McKinney, net, net, for what the Packers had versus what they have, it's a net positive. It's a net positive. Aaron Jones, D-Bock, Campbell for McKinney and Jacobs? You're telling me you wouldn't take that?
I would certainly take it. And not only that, they still have $10 million in cap room left to work with from that math equation. So they're not done yet. I think these are the biggest splash that Goody's going to make in this free agency. But guys, the way I look at this, the Packers are better than they were this morning. With Josh Jacobs at running back, look, we can all mourn the loss of Aaron Jones and what he did for the Packers while simultaneously being excited for what Josh Jacobs brings. Because he brings a physical running style. Mm-hmm. He brings reliability. He brings youth. He brings the ability to tote the rock more. All things that Jordan Love is going to need to continue to build this offense. And Xavier McKinney is a total home run. I mean, Jeff Hafley we know what he wants in a safety, and he got that in Xavier McKinney. So I think this is a good, it's a great day for Green Bay Packers. I love Aaron Jones, and it'll be weird to see him not in a Packer uniform, but you have to admit, the on-field product for the Green Bay Packers, it got better today.
I think, real quick, it's worth mentioning because of who the Packers lost to and who the Packers continue to lose to in the playoffs. A little edge help. The 49ers are signing Leonard Floyd. So they continue to find.
They do love doing.
They just find what guys to load up on that front four to make your life hell.
I think the reason why you guys are saying Josh Jacobs is better than Aaron Jones and they improved is only simply because of age. Because based off performance that I've seen,
availability.
Dude, he was hurt last year. Josh Jacobs was banged up last year. Josh Jacobs has had one really, really good year, and I'm not taking anything away from him whatsoever.
But don't you trust your Packers and Matt LaFleur to put Josh Jacobs in a position where he can rep? If he could lead the league in rushing with the Raiders, a dump franchise, then I'd like to think at age 26 that he could do something with the Green Bay Packers.
To be seen, but I would have personally preferred us keeping Aaron Jones and drafting a running back and doing it that way versus investing this money into Josh Jacobs. Now, you said 12 and a half guarantee, so it sounds like they'll be able to move on from him after year one or year two or something like that. But I just preferably think that this team would have been in better position. It's not a net positive in wins, right? I don't see Josh Jacobs being the difference maker that Aaron Jones couldn't have been the difference maker. We saw the impact Aaron Jones had at the end of the season when healthy that he had on this roster. Do you really think Josh Jacobs can have more of an impact more consistently? Is that why you guys still think this is a great deal?
He can lead to wins if he's on the field more often. I just remember last season, every time we were doing our game pregames, we were keeping our eye on the Friday injury report and Sunday pregame, who's active, who's inactive. And there was a huge drop off from Aaron Jones to A.J. Dillon. Of course there is, because A.J. Jones is a really good back. The team changes when you have an elite running back there. Josh Jacobs has proven, not only is he younger, but he's proven he can stay healthy more. And it's no knock to Aaron Jones. He's had a long career. He's 30 years old. So
let's break it down this way, as you say that, Brad. 26-year-old two-time Pro Bowler versus one-time All-Pro over 29 years old, unavailable half the season.
I think that availability part, you can't ignore that.
But you can't. He's getting older at the toughest position to stay healthy.
I would have preferred signing somebody and hoping that he can give me 13 games next season.
Hope is not a strategy, dude. How many times have we talked about that?
It worked out well for us this year having a very fresh and healthy Aaron Jones. He was a difference maker.
But at
the end of the year, he played a big role. When the Packers went on a roll, he played a big role in those games.
Isn't too much at risk, though? You can't risk him getting injured and then losing a season because you don't have a capable running back that can stay healthy. Losing a season to win the Super Bowl. Would we agree we need a capable, healthy running back to win the Super Bowl?
If the Packers did not sign Josh Jacobs today and they went into the season rolling with Aaron Jones and drafting somebody, nobody would be sitting here saying, boy, oh boy, the Packers should have got Josh Jacobs. But that's where we're at the running back position. Whereas you look on the defensive side of the ball at safety, if the Packers didn't sign anybody at safety, we'll be saying, what the heck are the Packers doing? The position of running back, it was a need to try to improve and try to build some depth, but it wasn't a position of need where you had to cut Aaron Jones and sign Josh Jacobs. I understand that this is not about 2024. This is about 2027. That's what this is about. You got somebody who's younger to bring you production for more years than what Aaron Jones
but
is
also,
gonna give you. I understand.
If it's net neutral of a results on the field, then that's a net positive that you have the 3 years potentially with Josh Jacobs and you have someone more potentially reliable who's younger. I know you're coming around. It's just the losing of Aaron Jones, who was so great to the franchise, and that's why Packer fans are great. But that's why you're also not a GM, because GMs have to make the decisions taking emotion out of it, looking purely at numbers. And people continue to be conflicted, right? Way better position keeping Jones, a good leader, could teach the rookies. Sorry, I think that Josh is way younger and healthier. 30 years old, coming off an injury-plagued season, I'm fine with the move if he wasn't willing to take a pay cut again. And honestly, as harsh as that sounds, I think that's the best take. I'm fine with moving on from Aaron Jones, even though he wasn't willing to take a pay cut. Even though Jason Wilde joins us and tells us, I think Aaron Jones deserves better. Great. guess what? It's a business. Someone could deserve better and not get what they were supposed to get.
And it's not that they don't want Aaron Jones. Goody just had his number. You have to factor in age, availability, production, when healthy, for sure, in that equation. And Goody said, this is my number. I just can't go over knowing what the question marks might be for Aaron Jones in 2024 and beyond. So, look, I'm not going to lie. Josh Jacobs for $12 million a year, kind of a one-year deal, and let's see. It's kind of rich for my blood. It's a little
bit
surprising.
Rich.
But he had his number for Aaron Jones, couldn't reach it, and Goody, like good GMs do, is cold-blooded. Cold-blooded.
Again, this is one of those things that is going to be to be determined. The grade is going to be incomplete for me until I see what's on the field. Where I look at a Xavier McKinney before he gets on the field, I know this is an upgrade because that is a position that we needed to upgrade. We needed somebody that fits the mold of what works in this defense that Jeff Hafley is trying to implement. When it comes to the running back position, this will be incomplete until I see results on the field from Josh Jacobs.
800-990-3776, 800-990-ESPN. A ton of reaction on the ESPN Wisconsin talk and text line as we're reacting to the fact that Aaron Jones was released. Josh Jacobs was signed for 4 years, $48 million, 12 and a half guaranteed. But I think, I think I just need to bring up Xavier McKinney, who is a 24-year-old stud who's going to be on the. When's the last time the Packers had two all pros on the back end? Jair Alexander is an all pro when healthy and when playing. Xavier McKinney, you now have two guys, whether it's 3-4, 4-3, zone, man. You got guys who can play back there. They need to fill it in a little bit more, but that's what the draft's for. They still have $10 million in cap space. They can't be done. They literally just can't be done because they're not going to fill the rest of the roster with just rookies to step in there.
I should say $10 million created in cap space just from today. They have more than $10 million, like from the subtraction of D-Bock, Campbell, and Jones, adding Josh Jacobs. And actually, no, I need to go back and change that. Now we know Josh Jacobs' number. It's more like $6 million created today after those five transactions. But they have more than that in general to do free agency.
800-990-3776. Let's go to, all right, he just dropped off as I was going to go to him. He wanted to say, the title, Chris, I think it said, thinks Goody's going to draft a running back.
Running back high in the draft.
Yeah, I disagree with that.
Yeah, I disagree too.
Yeah, now that you have your horse, you want it, like, you don't pay any more at that position.
Y'all better be careful. Goody, he's shown something. He shows that he is going to get rid of whoever he wants to. At the end of the day, he was ready to move on from Aaron Rodgers.
No,
he moved on from Aaron
Rodgers. We're talking specifically about the running back position.
I'm talking about
right
the running
now.
Back position that, based off the, again, I haven't seen all the specifics of what it looks like from year to year, but if you're talking about 12 and a half guaranteed, I'm not a mathematician like my boy Brad is over here, but 48 divided by 4 is $12 million. And so if he has 12 and a half guaranteed, that means that after year one, this could be a year by year thing. I would not be surprised if they were to draft somebody in order to get ready to get somebody who's cheaper to be the replacement.
We're talking about early, though.
I'm talking about third round. That's early to me.
That's really, you jumped in there, and I was like, all right.
So you think of first?
I'm
thinking second or third round. Second will probably be the high end. Third
no,
round
not second either. You have a first and 2 seconds. If you do that with a running back with all the defensive holes you need to fill long term.
That's why I said third.
You can find value at the right. You can find an undrafted free agent who turns into something.
I can see
acting like I'm going to utilize first or second round capital. Pat on the east side, 800-990-3776. Welcome in to Kyle Bruston-Ortman.
Yeah, hi. You know, I like everything the Packers did today, with the exception of like cutting Aaron Jones. That one really, really hurts. And I think we could have kept both of them. I mean, kept Josh Jacobs and also kept Jones. I know they said they're going to cut him. I'm not sure he's technically cut just yet. Maybe they could still, keep him somehow if he does take a pay cut.
Pat, you sound like Kyle Wallace when Kyle first found out.
You sound fantastic, Pat. Don't let him talk to you.
No. Look, he loves Aaron Jones, but Aaron Jones was released, and Aaron Jones is going to test the free agent market, and he's not coming back.
The Packers released it. The Packers had a whole grab. Once I saw on the Green Bay Packers,
thank you, Pat.
I said, oh, no, this is official.
I'm shocked by this. I am absolutely shocked by this, that, Kyle's not trusting this. That Kyle, who would I trust Goody at all costs, it takes Aaron Jones, who is a 29-year-old turning 30, who's been injury prone last year, getting older at the position that is being devalued the most from a money standpoint, and you want to bring him back versus having someone who's a little bit more secure, even just for 1 year?
How about this? If this was the Chicago Bears doing it, how would you feel about it? Would you say, oh man, shoot, the Chicago Bears just got better? Or like, shoot, that's right, the Chicago Bears, that's a dumb move.
If the Chicago Bears cut a Matt Forte a year too early when they were a surprise team with a young quarterback and a team that needs some type of veteran presence, and where we had Jason Willey come on and say he doesn't know who's the person that's going to step up to fill the void. He believes it's going to be filled, but he can't identify anybody. I would say, ooh, that's a weird move to get rid of Matt Forte. I think it's a move for us to get rid of Aaron Jones that, again, hopefully it pans out, but there is no guarantee that this is going to pan out. I like having both of the guys teamed
together.
There's
no guarantee that a 30-year-old Aaron Jones would be healthy. Like, I mean, I'll take the better bet is that Josh Jacobs will play more games than Aaron Jones next year.
I agree with that.
No matter where it is. More productive, more reliable. I want that for Jordan Love and this young offense than I do wondering what my game plan's going
to
be.
Is this team, are they closer to a Super Bowl by having Josh Jacobs versus not having Aaron Jones? Is this team closer to a Super Bowl?
Yes, because they also added Xavier McKinney,
Move?
Off the specific, if you had Xavier McKinney and Aaron Jones, you still think this team is closer to a Super Bowl. Do you think Josh Jacobs makes this team closer to the Super Bowl offensively than having Aaron Jones?
I think he's more available, which, yes, results in more wins.
Yes, it's a yes.
Because I think Goody spent the whole season wondering, when's Aaron Jones coming back? When am I going to do the offense? Do you remember, what was the game plan where, wasn't there a game week where there was a full game plan that Matt LaFleur put together, and then last minute he heard that someone wasn't playing, and it was like, was that Aaron Jones?
A D-back or somebody.
Coaches want to know who's in their plane. If you're reliable, you know, availability is the best ability. That is such a huge asset, and that will result in more wins, more continuity, and more success.
You know why it's yes? Is because the only time that, like, I've heard arguments against releasing Aaron Jones continues to be the leadership void. Oh, carrying the G. Oh, like, yes, I love Aaron Jones, but this is a business. This isn't lovey-dovey. Like, in again, he was great for those 3-4 games down the stretch, but he wasn't that great after he pulled his hamstring week one, and then he sprained his MCL. And even when he came back from the hamstring before the MCL, he wasn't that great then either. So I want reliability. It's a great move for the Green Bay Packers. And I'll hear from you guys, 800-990-3776 on the other side. But first, Kyle, you need to tell us about the window that the Green Bay Packers continue to be in.
Yeah, the window the Packers continue to be in is a window kind of like Universal Windows Direct. And I've been telling you that windows from Universal perform better and last longer. They've got super spacer technology that helps keep the edge of the glass warmer, holds the window sill longer. It makes the window last up to 5 times longer than other window systems. And that's what Goody's trying to tell you. He thinks that Josh Jacobs is going to last 5 times longer than Aaron Jones, to be seen. But Universal Windows Direct, you know they are legit. But here, let's talk about a few more things. Make a great first impression and increase your home's curb value with a new entry door from Universal Windows Direct. Clogged gutters will cause more damage to your home, foundation problems, basement flooding, and more. With Universal Windows Direct, you'll never have to worry about cleaning your gutters ever again. Call today at 414-410-2000. That's 414-410-2000 to schedule your free in-home estimate today. And for every 2 windows you buy, you get the next 2 free. Tell them I told you to call and get an additional $250 off your next project. For the last windows you'll ever need, go to UniversalWindowsDirect.com. That's UniversalWindowsDirect.com. And like me, you'll be saying, I love my windows.
Justin Milwaukee, Packer Steve, and any others, 800-990-3776. You're next on KBN.
This is Kyle Brustin Nortman.
I'm about being young, wild, and free.
No, you're not.
You're not
young, wild, and free.
Every time I ask you to do something,
I check with a girlfriend.
Wait, why are you going personal? Why are you going to talk about business?
I can still be free with a lady.
On ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com. Aaron Jones' time with a green and gold is done. React here. 94.5 ESPN.
Produced
still have some delays along westbound 94, basically from 27th Street all the way through to almost Holly Road. The eastbound side is backing up just a bit all the way through the stadium interchange. Southbound 41 is quieted down nicely. We're looking really good all the way from Highway Q to the zoo. Northbound 43, slowing a little bit right around the North Avenue curve. And then the southbound side's heavy from Fond du Lac Avenue down through the Marquette interchange. Traffic is brought to you by the Delafield Brewhouse. Enjoy Naga Wicked Pale Ale Beer Battered Cod at the Delafield Brewhouse. Available Fridays for lunch and dinner. Drink ale, live lager, the Delafield Brewhouse. And check in the TMJ4 Storm Team forecast. Tonight, partly cloudy skies, breezy and mild, a low of 48. Tomorrow, partly cloudy, windy and warm with a high of 68. From the WTMJ Traffic Center, I'm Debbie Lazaga, 94.5 ESPN.
Football guy.
Good morning, Tausch. How are you?
Football guy.
Old T's a little, I'm not feeling 100%.
Coming at it from different views.
No, just I think with all that little stuff that's going around and the long trip back from the loo. I'm going to grind.
Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Also sponsored by Coors Light. Weekdays 9 to noon on 94.5 ESPN. And available wherever you get your podcasts with Wisconsin On Demand.
Right now, the prices of diamonds are probably the lowest we'll see in our lifetime.
Diamond prices are low, low, low. Here's why.
It was hard to meet new people during COVID.
When a person meets their soulmate, they usually get engaged about 39 months later.
People started dating again only about 36 months ago.
Most of the people who got engaged during COVID
or immediately after COVID
were already in a relationship before the COVID lockdown began.
The Wall Street Journal even published a story about all of this.
Low sales of engagement rings created a worldwide oversupply of diamonds.
But now, engagement ring sales are beginning to pick up again.
By the end of next spring, this temporary oversupply will be gone.
And diamond prices will start climbing like crazy.
If you ever wanted to own a big diamond, this is the year to do it.
Find the Kesslers nearest you at kesslersdiamonds.com.
If you want to own a big diamond, the time is now.
We all share the same roads, but when an accident happens, we don't always share the same consequences. Big trucks can cause big damage. Injuries can be severe and may require a lifetime of care and compensation. Call Gruber Law Offices today. We can help you from the safety and comfort of your own home. Our virtual sign-up process is quick and easy. Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all.
Life's better with American Family Insurance because our home policies help protect your dreams and come with peace of mind. Save up to 25% by bundling home, auto, and life. American Family Insurance. Get a quote, find an agent at amfam.com.
Products not available in every state. Discounts may not apply to all coverages on an auto or home policy. Discounts do not apply to life insurance policies. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating companies, American Family Life Insurance Company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
The Bucks Bar Network, presented by Michelob Ultra and Bally Sports Wisconsin, boasts the best spots to cheer on the deer when you're not at Fiserv Forum. With official Bucks Bar Network locations throughout the entire state, you can catch every single game. Pair the edge of your seat action, freakish plays, and championship caliber Bucks basketball with a Michelob Ultra. Visit bucks.com/bars to find the Bucks Bar Network location near you.
This is Kyle Brustin Nortman, KBN, on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
A lot of great insight from KBN Nation. Paul in the 262. Jones was phenomenal in the last five games last year. And a big reason why they did what they did. That being said, in the first 14 games last year, he rushed for just 320 yards. I also see some stuff on YouTube at ESPN Milwaukee. I thought this was a good way to put it. We can all say that we'll miss the cool guy 33 is and was and what he did on the field, but also objectively see that this looks like a sound football decision. This is business, not friendliness. That was Jack on YouTube at ESPN Milwaukee. I'm Ben Brust alongside Kyle Wallace, Brad Nortman, 800-990-ESPN. Let's go to Justin in Milwaukee. Welcome into Kyle Brust and Nortman. Thanks for holding.
Thanks, guys. Thanks for having me on. I agree with the
the trade, and it pains me to say that because it means I agree with Ben Brust. That's not a good place to be usually.
Cool.
But
Yeah,
this is the right way to go. You take a much younger running back on a multi-year deal, lock him in, and Aaron Jones was an older running back, and he wanted a multi-year deal, and I just can't see him being the value for the Packers or available for him. So it's a good move.
Appreciate the call, Justin, 800-990-ESPN.
Yeah, you know, I'm just looking at Josh Jacobs versus Aaron Jones stats since 2019 when Jones was kind of just a backup guy for the first couple of years. So 2019, they were both feature guys. Josh Jacobs has more total rush yards, more rushing TDs, more scrimmage yards, more production, more available. So I just think when you look at it and say, Josh Jacobs is certainly no scrub, right? He is a good player, multiple-time Pro Bowler. He was AP 1 year when he led the league in rushing. So I just think when you look at it, you got younger, likely more healthier, at least the same production, if not more, over the last, 5 years when they were both marquee backs. So it's a bummer because we like Aaron Jones. We like what he brings to the locker room. We like his personality. He's the guy you want to root for. You wish there was more Aaron Jones in the league. So just the NFL circle of life just keeps on spinning.
So you feel more confident with Josh Jacobs as the running back for the Green Bay Packers next year than you do with Aaron Jones?
I do.
Okay.
Yes, I do too.
I mean, that's perfectly fine. Maybe it's because I have not seen it. I've seen Josh Jacobs perform, and yes, he was on a meh football team. I remember the Packers played against the Raiders this year. You weren't like, oh my gosh, Josh Jacobs is destroying us, running all over this bad defense.
Well, they literally changed their philosophy. If you look at his splits from the first half of the year, the second half of the year, after they fired their incompetent coach in
Josh McDaniels.
Yeah. Antonio Pierce started giving Josh Jacobs the ball, and he became a guy that they could build their identity through, which is great to know that you can have a consistency of having a running back to build your identity through when you have somebody who showed as much promise as Jordan Love is showing, and as much as those wide receivers have. You want somebody that you know you can rely on, and that's why I go back to he had what Paul said. Just 320 yards in the first 14 freaking games. That's not enough for a team that has a Jordan Love and a Dontavian Wicks, Romeo Doubs, Christian Watson, Jaden Reed that can all continue to flourish.
He was hurt.
But that's a concern.
That's a concern at that age. He's a running back. Am I losing my mind? When, you watch football?
When is
being an old running back good? When is it good to have an old running back?
Going into next season.
I know you love him, but let it go.
It's not even about loving him, fellas. It's about the fact that you know when he is healthy, he's on the football field for this Green Bay Packers team.
He
had a down.
He's had injury issues before
This was a down year health-wise, but when he was healthy,
nothing like getting healthier when you get older in the NFL. Everyone knows that happens.
We just ignoring the last 5 games of last season.
If he was able to do things that on the field all year that he did similar to that at the end of the year, we wouldn't even be having this conversation.
We talked about stats of when they give him 20 carries or more.
But they don't do that over the last five years anyway, so why even keep him?
I'm just saying, based off statistics, when they gave him the ball a lot of times in games, the Packers ended up winning a lot of those football games. They found a lot of success. I don't want us to say, oh, we signed Josh Jacobs and act like this dude was a scrub or a bum. He was always injured. No, this dude was a positive contributor for this football team, and I do not think that is a net positive in 2024 having Jacobs over Jones.
I just think when you're looking going forward, knowing what we know about Aaron Jones, is he likely to be more healthy or less healthy? He's more likely to be less healthy because he's just more hits, more runs, more injuries. And this team needs stability at this position. We saw what happens when your feature back is out, right? I mean, it's just A.J. Dillon. The offense is plodding along. I think Goody looked at it and said, we can't deal with that for another year. We have to have reliability at the running back position.
Gotta have a better plan. Jacobs. The time is now. I don't want to hear none of that. I want to see performance. I want to see 1,400 yards, Josh Jacobs. Because we ain't getting performance. I don't want to see you getting stuffed on a 3rd-and-1 or a 4th-and-1 like Quadzilla.
You're going to be tough on Josh Jacobs, aren't you? I'm going to be extremely tough on Josh Jacobs.
He's replacing a great running back. Yeah. I expect no drop-off whatsoever. Ever in that running back position.
Ron in the key. Kyle is irrationally loyal. Still rides with Favre. This is so on brand. Packer Steve, welcome into Kyle Bruston Ortman, 800-990-ESPN.
Gentlemen, I believe that Kyle is right. I believe if
he did it properly, he would have kept both of them because it would have been set up properly. Aaron Jones has done so much for them, and he would have done it properly, and you have Josh Jacobs.
Thank you for the call, Packer Steve. Another word that you use, probably, and I just in the 262, he can't. Oh, properly. Okay, I liked my probably better, putting words into his mouth. Justin, the 262, he can't handle 20 plus touches, and you know why we know that's true? Because anytime that he has, he's been getting hurt. I'm not going to beat a dead horse. I can't convince Kyle to change his mind, and I know that. Basically, what this comes down to is Josh Jacobs needs to be the world's greatest running back. Otherwise, this was a bad move. But also at the same time, even if Aaron Jones plays 10 to 11 games and has a good 10 to 11 games, I'd rather have Josh Jacobs at 17 games if it's a little slightly less production.
There's no doubt that Aaron Jones helped this team win when he was playing, and when he was playing healthy. How many games did he also play that he was on a pitch count and kind of invisible for most of the game? So yes, when healthy, he is a very capable back. That's why I'm curious what his free agent market's going to be. The problem is he's just not healthy enough. You can't have one game where you can trust him to be in there and be a difference maker, and the next game you can't.
If he had QC kinetics, maybe he could. We would trust him a little more.
I mean, we would. I mean, because if you're trying to fight off injury, you got to go to QC kinetics because you want to be your healthiest too, so you can be relied on, so you can do the things that you want to do with life. I mean, it's beautiful outside today. You probably want to go for a walk. You probably want to play some golf. Maybe go for a run. But if you have aching joints that are giving you pain, QC Kinetics can help you get your life back. Now is the time to start enjoying your life with QC Kinetics, who's the nation's leader in regenerative medicine. This is lasting joint pain with no surgery, no drugs, and no downtime. QC Kinetics have been transforming lives for pro athletes like me, former pro athlete, for decades. And now the life-changing treatment is available for you so you can do the things you want to do. It's a natural solution with no drugs, no downtime, and no surgery. QC Kinetics has given thousands of patients their mobility back. It's time to reclaim yours this spring and summer. Call QC Kinetics today for a free consultation. Call 414-285-3474. That's 414-285-3474. 414-285-3474.
More Kyle Bruston-Orban hearing from KBN Nation. Josh Jacobs signed the Packers. Aaron Jones released. And Xavier McKinney. We haven't talked a lot about him. They got their guy at safety. 800-990-ESPN. We'll be back.
This is Kyle Bruston-Orban, KBN.
You said they are a reflection of their head coach.
Yes, yep. He saw it as he proved with you by signing that damn jersey you had on. You think Campbell would have signed that jersey?
On ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
We do have some delays westbound on 94 as you're making your way out of the 16th Street area all the way through the stadium. So it is going to be a bit heavy there, so be careful. Eastbound is slowing down coming out of the stadium interchange heading towards 27th Street. Southbound 43, slow from Fond du Lac Avenue down through the Marquette and over the high-rise bridge. Northbound's a little slow from right around the North Avenue curve up towards Locust. Traffic is brought to you by Johnson & Sons Paving. Potholes are a pain when they pop up in your asphalt. Johnson & Sons Paving can patch or replace the whole lot. Book an appointment now at johnsonandsonspaving.com. And check in the TMJ4 Storm Team forecast tonight. Partly cloudy skies, breezy and mild, low of 48. Tomorrow, partly cloudy, windy and warm with a high of 68. From the WTMJ Traffic Center, I'm Debbie Lozaga on 94.5 ESPN.
And ESPN Radio Extra Point. With Evan Cohen, Chris Canty, and Michelle Smallman.
I want to go back to one thing, Smalls. You're not as high on this, obviously, as we are. Would you not have done this if you were the Steelers?
No, I probably would have because of the financial reasons, because it is so low risk. It's unbelievable. And This allows you to add another quarterback to the quarterback room, compete for the starting job while allowing yourself the resources to add to your team elsewhere because you're not sunk by the quarterback position. But I don't feel great about it. Feels like yet another Band-Aid or another bridge. bridge until they inevitably get there. And if I'm a Steelers fan, I could understand being frustrated.
Here's why the front office and ownership feels good about it, though. It represents an opportunity to upgrade quarterback, and that might represent an opportunity to push the negotiations with your head coach across the goal line. That is probably the biggest, most consequential move that the Pittsburgh Steelers have to make this offseason is signing Mike Tomlin to a contract extension.
We all hear the radio ads about the IRS. They tell you to be afraid, to be scared, and they try to frighten you into calling. I'm not here to do that. Tax Relief Advocates is different. TRA is here to tell you that if you owe money to the IRS, whether it's $5,000, $50,000, or $500,000, we have a solution. It doesn't matter if you're sitting in your car, at work, or with your kids, no matter where you are, call now. 800-575-6759. Don't lose hope. TRA can eliminate or reduce what you owe to the IRS. There is zero risk to you. If we can't reduce your tax debt, then you pay nothing. Our passion is taxes and helping individuals fix their IRS problems. We have a 5-star rating on Google and Yelp and an A+ with the Better Business Bureau. You don't need to be afraid of the IRS any longer. End your tax nightmare today by visiting us online at TRA.com or call 800-575-6759. That's 800-575-6759. Tax Relief Advocates. Real solutions for real people.
That to-do list you have needs one more thing. Chill. It's an easy thing to do. Just crack open an ice-cold Coors Light and chill. Take the afternoon off and binge-watch anything. Go to happy hour and stay for a couple hours. Who's counting anyways? Or hang out with just your dog because you've had enough human interaction this week. Whatever you do, do it with a Coors Light. Mountain Cold Refreshment, made to chill. 2020 Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. Celebrate responsibly.
Make it a real Mad March with a playoff payout at Pottawatomie. Every week, you could score your share of 100 grand in cash and free play. Play this March for drawing entries. Win each Thursday. Plus, the prizes refresh every week for even more winners. The playoff payout at Pottawatomie, Milwaukee. It's anyone's game. For more details, visit paysbig.com/payout. Must be 21 and a club member to play.
You're listening to Kyle, Brust, and Nortman on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
Justin calling me out on Twitter. Sure, at Ben Brust, Jacobs is younger than Jones. He also has 128 more career carries and missed a handful of games last year, too. Sure, everyone's going to get injured. He didn't miss as much and obviously had more production of total yards than Aaron Jones did last year. But what I will say is, just because he has more carries doesn't mean that's a bad thing necessarily. I know that sounds backwards, but hear me out for a second. If Aaron Jones is 4 years older than Josh Jacobs and, like, is getting injured, that means he's not able to carry as heavy of a workload and he's getting older. So don't really see why that matters. Rick in Pewaukee, 800-990-3776. Welcome to Kyle, Brust, and Nortman. As we're breaking down all things, Josh Jacobs to the Packers, Aaron Jones released, and Xavier McKinney signed at safety.
Okay, guys, question I have is a little bit different. I like the idea of getting Jacobs, but I'm just wondering if, A, will agents want to work with Goody after what he did with this, saying that he loves him and he's definitely going to be back? And B, are players going to be willing to take a pay cut if they, you know, see what the Packers did where they cut Aaron Jones the following year? I'm just wondering, you know, the public relations thing for Goody and how it's going to be, and how would Brad see that when it comes to all of this?
That's a great question. I'll say this. Players are self-interested. They just are. And they look at their circumstances.
Shocking. Yeah. Kyle and I didn't notice that.
Yeah, in a tunnel vision, right? They're not going to look at this and say, can I trust Brian Gutekunst? Can I trust the Green Bay Packers? They're just going to look out for number one. And it's just the reality of it. So if it benefits them to be with the Green Bay Packers in a lot of ways, this sounds harsh, but then they'll do it. And if not, they'll go their separate ways. So I think agents are sharks. GMs are sharks. And players are trying to get as much as they can as fast as they can.
Goody put out a statement that I think is, as Jason Wilde would call it, reading on the radio. We want to thank Aaron for his unwavering commitment to the Packers and the community over the past 7 seasons. It has certainly been one of the hardest decisions we've had to make in my time with the Packers, and not lightly. He not only has had a significant impact on the field and in the locker room, which is Kyle's biggest concern, but he is one of the most beloved players in our community. We wish him nothing but the best for Aaron and his entire family moving forward. Continues, today is a tough day for the Packers and our community. Making sure I got that I'm not reading. So the quote, that was Goody. This one's LaFleur. Today is a tough day for the Packers and our community. As a good player as Aaron is on the field, he's an even better person. When I arrived in Green Bay as a first-time head coach, he was instrumental in establishing our winning culture and always served as the greatest example of what it meant to be a Packer. Aaron will always be one of the best players I had the opportunity to coach. He, his son Junior, his mom, and family will be missed. Kyle, cue the tears.
I mean, everything that they said, everything that I've been trying to convey to you all. I think the big thing, talking about winning culture, and when you want to win championships, you need to cultivate and grow that winning culture. And now, instead of having somebody in there, and granted, he has not won a championship with the Packers.
What if I told you I had an Aaron Jones statement that he put out on Instagram?
All right, let's hear the Aaron Jones.
Thank you for everything, Green Bay. Signature. And then in the post, I appreciate all my teammates making the past 7 years truly special and love you all.
Oh, wow.
That's it.
That's shorter than I thought it'd be.
I know. I thought it was a little shocking.
I guess that's what happens when you feel like you've been devalued.
You think he feels bitter?
Oh, yeah.
He wasn't prepared. And as Jason Wilde said, that absolutely meant a big thing. Like, the Packers are probably trying to work on this. But imagine you renegotiating a contract where somebody's trying to say, hey, we want to bring you back, but we can't bring you back for this number after we renegotiated the year before. And then all of a sudden you find out that your team goes and signs somebody for a big number so that you value more than them. You realize that you are now going to be second fiddle to somebody else. You are no longer the big dog in the backfield. They are bringing somebody else in to replace you. That is a tough pill to swallow for any person.
Well, and every player, especially if you were drafted by that team, you think you're going to be a lifer for that team. Like, I thought I was going to be a lifer for the Panthers, but the reality is business happens, things change, priorities change, then you have to go somewhere else, and then the first time you see someone wearing your jersey number, playing your position in the team that you thought you were going to be with for life, a shock. You feel betrayed. So I get it. I totally get what he's experiencing.
I hope the Packers establish and let Josh Jacobs know, when you come here, we're talking about winning championships, and this is a culture that you need to basically get with. That's what it is.
And look, what I did like, and from Josh Jacobs and Devontae Adams, when they did move on from McDaniels in Vegas, like, Josh Jacobs wore a C. He was a captain. Xavier McKinney wore a C. He was a captain. So if we're looking for leadership, those are two guys that had C's on their jersey, and they're coming here to Green Bay.
That's a good point.
It is. That's a fantastic point. A fantastic point. Two guys that haven't won a lot of football games, but have a desire to be a leader, but have a desire to win as well. So that is something that, when we talk about winning culture, that is the most important thing in Green Bay right now, because culture, Brad, as you know, it is, and you too, Ben, as well, is that you can be great one moment, but all it takes is one bad thing to really mess up what you got going on, and that's my biggest fear.
Well, and players will crave, especially coming from New York or coming from Las Vegas, they're going to crave a stable, firm foundation culture like the Green Bay Packers. They're going to enjoy what they see. After experiencing that bad, they're going to come to Green Bay and be like, ooh, we like this.
Maybe so, that number 3 NFLPA ranking is helping the Packers today in free agency.
Or also Jordan Love having the same agency as Xavier McKinney as well definitely helped that too.
Doesn't hurt.
And Jordan Love just being a flat-out baller last year.
Yeah.
I mean, look.
Guys want to win.
Guys want to win, and guys watch. They all watch those games. They saw what he did at Jerry World. Xavier McKinney's like, well, hopefully he didn't pay too much attention to. Maybe he's like, look, the Packers are so bad that I watched my former quarterback, Tommy DeVito, run all over them. I can save them. Sorry.
Oh, that's. I can laugh now.
Come on. We can laugh at the Tommy DeVito game. We got Xavier McKinney to stop
today,
him.
Today's not the day to be laughing, fellas. I've lost the loved one on my team. Not in life, but on my team for my Green Bay
Packers. I'm curious to get the perspective of Brian Bulaga, who joins us next. But make sure you tune into Thanalysis and his show, The Thanalysis Show, every week on Bucks Plus. Thanalysis Antetokounmpo sits down with special guests to have fun and honest conversations with NBA stars like Damian Lillard, Donovan Mitchell, basketball media royalty Jay Williams, and there's more lined up as part of the season two. So find the Thanalysis Show on Bucks.com/plus in the Bucks app or on Apple, Spotify, and anywhere you get your podcasts. Brian Bulaga, former Packers tackle, who ended up wanting to be a Packer even longer, but didn't, will be able to shed some insight as to what happened with Aaron Jones next.
The Packers are releasing Aaron Jones. Share your thoughts here. 94.5 ESPN. Even when you think you know what's going on.
The chefs are 7, ooh, and they cannot win a Super Bowl.
You can never be too sure.
Until Taylor Swift, on her birthday, says no to Kelce with an engagement ring.
Jen, Gabe, and Chewy.
Does he have to ask her before getting the ring? Or no? Can he just give her the ring?
Morning 7 to 9 on 94.5 ESPN and available wherever you get your podcasts with Wisconsin On Demand.
Hey, it's Kyle Walls for Universal Windows Direct. I've been telling you that windows from Universal perform better and last longer. Call today at 414-410-2000 to schedule your free in-home estimate today. And for every 2 windows you buy, you get the next 2 free. Plus, a free upgrade to triple pane glass, and they'll double your energy tax credit. Restrictions do apply. Tell them I told you to call and get an additional $250 off your next project. For the last windows you'll ever need, go to UniversalWindowsDirect.com. And like me, you'll be saying, I love my windows.
Looking for a totally rad flavor adventure, bro chachos? Look no further than Surfer Boy Pizza as seen in Stranger Things. Each mouthwatering variety contains rich tomato sauce, delicious mozzarella cheese, and a gnarly range of toppings. The crust is crispy on the outside and airy on the inside. You'll think it was hand-tossed by the Surfer Boy Pizza dudes themselves. Look for it in the freezer aisle at your local store and buckle up your taste buds with Surfer Boy Pizza.
Nelnet Incorporated, the nation's largest, most respected student loan servicer, has document imaging technology from James Imaging Systems. Facilities coordinator, Sunday Heideman.
James Imaging has been a local provider for us for many years. They are reliable, they're responsible, and they take care of all of our printer needs.
Just what you'd expect from a 100% Wisconsin-owned and managed business technology company.
I think we get a great value with James Imaging, with their service and the contracts that we have with them, that our cost stays low and we get the most for our money.
Sunday, what's the benefit for you with James Imaging Systems?
It makes my job more enjoyable that I can count on these people to do what they're trained to do, and I have no worries because I know I'm going to be taken care of.
James Imaging Systems. Call 262-781-7700. James Imaging Systems, your local business technology partner.
ESPN Wisconsin's Mark Tosher here for my friends at Kohler Services. If you need a bath or shower remodel, turn to Kohler Services. Family owned for 150 years. Kohler is your Wisconsin manufacturer providing care for life. This month only, get $1,000 off your Luxtone shower and pay nothing until 2025. Visit KohlerServicesWI.com to request your free quote with fast, professional installation always included. Again, that's KohlerServicesWI.com.
It all starts next week. We're talking about the Guinness Basketball Hours. This is your chance to enjoy a free pint of Guinness at select locations throughout southeastern Wisconsin.
Beer.
Enjoy the basketball games and a Guinness all month at the Brewery, Trinity, Hooligans, Jack's American Pub, and Nomad. Tune in next week and follow ESPN Milwaukee on social for the exact dates, times, and locations of the Guinness Basketball Hours. Receive 3 pints of Guinness throughout the tournament with the Guinness Basketball Hours.
Hi, it's John Reitz from Great Midwest Bank. And you know, there's more to being a local Wisconsin bank than perfectly pronouncing Oconomowoc or Waukesha. Or is it Waukesha? But rest assured, at Great Midwest Bank, we understand the local community and economy because we're a part of it. At GMB, we provide customized lending products that others just can't offer. Experience a hometown banking difference. Head to greatmidwestbank.com. Great Midwest Bank, your simply local equal housing lender.
This is Kyle Brustin Nortman on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
Let's go, let's go. Let's go get some money, they playing.
I told her take this plan B and stop playing.
If you like what the Packers have done, because I think net positive, Josh Jacobs, Xavier McKinney, D-Bock, who hasn't been available,
Devondre
Campbell,
oh,
gone. I didn't say Aaron. Settle down, man. You are on edge.
Kyle's looking to
then go
fight.
Over to Potawatomi and place a bet on the Super Bowl odds, baby. I love jetting over there to cash in a winning ticket and place futures. But it's been my go-to place for a long time, and in May, they're opening their latest and greatest state-of-the-art retail sportsbook with a 2,000-square-foot video wall, luxury seating for over 200, an expanded food menu, and so much more. It's going to be the best place to be for everything, for watching games, for being the action. Mark your calendars. Don't miss the grand opening the first week of May. Bet big, bet bold, paysbig.com, baby. And we're going to hit a Ben same game parlay very, very, very soon. Joining us now on Kyle Bruston-Ortman before he joins the Homer Hour. A lot to get to in the next hour and 12 minutes with Brian Bulaga. Brian, welcome in first and foremost. How are you?
I'm good. How are you guys doing? A lot of news today, huh?
A lot of news. Not a typical Green Bay Packers legal tampering day with free agency.
No.
But it's been fun. And I think as a guy who's been in situations in the NFL, shed light on how hard it is to want something in terms of like being with the team and then not being able to get there, because it kind of feels like that's where Aaron Jones and Goody ultimately got to.
Yeah, I mean, this is was a big surprise to me, especially with everything that came out of Green Bay from Goody saying that we definitely want him back and see him as a member of this team. And I remember I mentioned it to you guys last week. Two sides need to come to an agreement here, right? This isn't just Aaron Jones accepting a pay cut and doing it again. You know, they got to kind of try to meet him halfway, and clearly they couldn't come to an agreement, and it's tough because I know Aaron, you know, loves Green Bay. He loved playing for the Packers, a great team guy, a great locker room guy, and it's a tough deal when you know, you get let go from a place that you love and you love to be and you wanted to be back. It's a tough thing, and looking from the outside in his situation, I still am not totally sold on the move. I'm just not. I think Aaron Jones fits what Green Bay does and what they want to do and how they what they need out of the running back position. But you know, when two sides can't come to an agreement, this is what happens, and Green Bay has moved on, and I'm sure Aaron Jones will be somewhere very soon.
Brian, when I was playing, I remember, as long as I wasn't the one being replaced, when our team would go out there and sign marquee guys, it caused a little bit of excitement in me. I was looking forward to getting to know these guys come OTAs and thinking like, oh, wow, like we're going for it. This is so uncharacteristic for Goody, for Green Bay, to be day one splash guys. What message do you think it's sending the team right now?
Yeah, I mean, this is, you know, kind of a turn from, you know, business as usual for Green Bay. I think it shows them that, or at least to the team, that they feel like they're close, right? They need a few more pieces and they feel like they're really close. And obviously we kind of look at this defense and know they're more than just a few pieces away. They need to make some big additions this offseason. It starts with the safety position. That was one position that I got to give Homer a hard time about, because I said they were probably going to go to free agency and get a guy that they know and like, and he told me there was no way.
No way. Said, no chance.
Yep, exactly. So I'm going to have to give him a hard time about that. But it shows the team and the guys in the locker room that, well, first, if you play well, you get rewarded on the team. If they're going to hand it out to free agents, they're going to pay guys if they play well, you know, that are currently on the roster. Obviously, the Aaron Jones thing kind of throws a little bit of a wrench in that thinking. But at the end of the day, they pay the guys they want to be there. So it motivates guys from that way, but it also sends that signal that, you know, we feel like we're a few guys away to being where we want to be. And that brings good energy to the building.
Brian, you talked about locker room, right? You talked about what this is going to mean for this locker room. What will the void mean for this Green Bay Packers team? Do you see there be any regression with the chemistry and trying to create a winning culture, no longer having Aaron Jones?
Well, you know, I think the culture is already in the building, right? I think the culture's been there for a long time. I mean, it was a culture that I got brought into and I accepted it, and it kind of feels like it's the same way there right now. And it's going to take a guy like Josh Jacobs a little bit of time to understand how things work. He's been on a perennial loser for essentially his whole career. And when you go to some of these perennial losers, and I was on one in LA, like sometimes not playing your best and you know, that kind of thing is just accepted because your team knows that we're probably not going to win. You know, it's a loser mentality, and you need to go to a winner to get that, you know, mindset change. So I'm hoping he's able to buy in really quick and get everything down. I'm not saying that the guy isn't talented. He clearly is. But there's a mindset change when you go from a team like Vegas, who doesn't do much and not much is expected of them, to a team like Green Bay, where now, especially after last year, the expectation is so high and you're a big money running back. Not a lot of, like, there's just not a lot of those guys. Obviously, we saw Saquon get paid and all that, but I think Jacobs was the highest earner if we look at it. So there's a lot of expectation on your shoulder now besides just, you know, rushing the ball 20 times, 30 times a game, you know, especially in this Green Bay offense. There's a lot that gets asked of the running backs.
I called Aaron Jones the Donald Driver of this football team. What do you think the reaction would have been had the Packers cut somebody like a Donald Driver?
Well, you know, it's hard to answer because it's, you know, everyone understands the business of this thing, right? Like nobody wants to see good guys walk out the locker room and you know, it'd be the same case as Donald Driver. Nobody wants to see guys leave, but everyone understands the business end of this thing. And sometimes guys get let go that just mean a little bit more to the locker room. You saw the statement that Goody and LaFleur put out. I mean, they normally don't put out those statements after guys have to be let go. So, it's going to be an adjustment for that offense that is young already to find guys now to step up and be that vocal leader. Obviously, Jordan Love is going to be expected to take the next step in his leadership role, but it needs to be more than just one guy. So it'll be interesting to see who kind of starts to step up on the offensive side of the ball to become that vocal leader like he was.
Who was the vocal leader when you were on the Packers, and how important is the vocal side of things? Because I feel like Jordan Love is really well respected, and maybe he can be a leader in holding guys accountable because he is able to, I mean, he was able to really get this team when they were 2-5 to still turn the corner.
Yeah, no, I mean, I think the guys that, like, there's two ways you look at leadership, right? There's some guys that lead by example, which was more my deal. I wasn't a really vocal rah-rah guy. It wasn't my thing. And some guys really embrace that, are able to, you know, get their message across and be genuine with it, which guys really respect if you're genuine. And I mean, guys that when I was there, it would be, you know, TJ Lang, Sitton, Aaron was always that way. You know, you see guys that are genuine with how they get their message across. And it's not fake. It's not forced. It's just who they are. But, you know, I always like to look at it as if you're yourself, if you be yourself and you just go about your business, and whether that's vocal or non-vocal or not really that rah-rah guy, or it's just go out and do your job. Guys see that and they follow that, whether it's one or the other. So I'm not saying that Aaron Jones didn't lead by example, which he did, but he was a guy that had a voice in the locker room. He was a veteran in the locker room, and guys respected him, and he was a great teammate. So that's going to be a hard leadership, you know, piece to replace for sure.
So lost in all of this, in this running back conversation, is Xavier McKinney, and obviously a huge part for this defense. What was your initial reaction to that, of the Packers basically paying top dollar for a free agent safety as opposed to going with a veteran route or even drafting?
Yeah, I mean, this was kind of as you started to see all the safeties that were hitting the market and would become available. To me, it started to seem like Green Bay was going to go all in on one of these guys, right? And I think they did a good job with the one they picked. Obviously, I don't have a bunch of knowledge on him. I mean, I've watched him in a few times when the Giants have played or when they played the Packers. I think he's a really good player. So it was definitely a good start on the defensive side of the ball to free agency, and we'll see what they continue to do as the days goes on here.
Do you feel like it's been a net positive day for the Packers?
Not net positive. I don't think a net positive. Wow. Yeah.
He's a smart man. He's a smart man.
So Xavier McKinney and Josh Jacobs, and you lose D-Bock, Aaron Jones, Campbell, like, it's hard for me to say that it's not. You brought in a young all-pro safety. You brought in a young who was rushing leader. In 20 seconds, why not?
Because these guys are unproven in winning scenarios. That's just really what it is.
There it is. No, I like that.
Brother, preach.
These guys are unproven in winning scenarios. I want to hear more of that from 5 to 6 on the Homer Hour. Brian Bulaga, Homer, up next in 2 minutes. Thanks for hanging out with us.
We do have some backups right now on westbound 894, all because of an accident.